everybody! Welcome! Welcome to Thursday, my Thursday Genshin stream. My name is Sarah Miller-Cruz. I'm the English Voice of Lumine and Genshin Impact. I am also Angela and Charles of Mana and Caitlin and Roxanne in Pokemon Masters. And I'm here with my dear friend, Beau!
Hey, hi everyone, how are you? Hi, my name is Beau and I am the English language voice for Chongyun in Genshin Impact, not Chris Pratt. That's a very topical joke. Like, if people are watching if people are watching this stream in like a year or something like that,
why would you say that?
But at the current time of recording, Chris Pratt has announced two major animated lead roles in like the space of a month, and it's a very funny meme at the minute. I'm the English voice of Chongyun. That's the primary thing I'm known for. I'm also in Trials of Mana, though. As Heath and Silphid. And a bunch of other things like Miraculous Ladybug. I'm getting my words the wrong way around. Miraculous Ladybug as Tatsu, and Onglade in the anime movie Children of the Sea, and like a bunch of other things. I'm forgetting them all right now. Maybe they'll come up later. But yay!
Yeah, at any time you could be like, I want to redo my intro. That's totally fair. Beau, I am so glad to have you here. I'm so excited to do this. Chongyun Hangout. I think this is going to be super fun, and I'm so glad you're hanging. Oh my gosh, sorry. It's raining in Genshin. I just got struck by lightning. Okay, we're moving. We're moving this tree. I feel like this is not safe. Anyway, I'm just so glad that you're here with me, and I'm glad that we're going to get to hang out while we do the Chongyun Hangout.
I know. I'm so happy to be here as well. Thank you for having me. I'm really glad we've been able to do this. We've been joking that, like, fate will throw some kind of spanner in the works.
Yeah,
that will completely ruin this. And I'm just still now just kind of like that, like, puppet monkey meme where his, like, eyes are going sideways. He's like that's me right now.
We're just waiting, something bad's gonna happen this whole time. Up until, like, literally an hour before, we were like,
Can I just say, when I did this stream with Karina, like, I'm probably jinxing it right here saying this. When I did, you know, when I went on Karina's stream and they said, like, hey, do you want to join me for the Chongyun Hangout? And we did two streams. And the reason we did two streams is when we got to the first one, they, like, clicked on the Hangout and it was like, oh, you don't have the 8 keys required or whatever. And it was like, what? I thought I had enough. And then they didn't have enough of... You know, they hadn't, like, unlocked the event. We just had, like, a Q&A thing, and then, like, a week later, actually did the Hangout. So.
That's so funny. Well, since we are about to go, like, meet Chongyun, I guess now's a really good time to ask you, like, what was it like... when you, like, found out that you were voicing Chongyun, and what's your favorite thing about him?
I was, like, really happy when I booked Chongyun, and it was kind of, like, the first... One of the cool things about it, actually, was it was, like, the first thing I did, during the pandemic and stuff. And basically, I won't draw out... things and tell a really long story, but basically before the pandemic I used to go to a studio to do all my auditions, mm-hmm. and I'd get directed and stuff like that. They have there's a studio I go to. They had this, like, cool little deal thing you can do where, like, they record your auditions for you and you get directed by lovely directors. So it was really nice because you didn't have to worry about all the stuff that we've had to worry about for the last 2 years, like recording at home and everything, and you also got directed as well, so you didn't have to, like, second guess yourself and be like, oh, was that good enough, did I do a good job there, you know, it's just like being in a session.
Are you talking about, sorry, just for clarification, are you talking about, like, you just, like, would go to the studio and this was a studio that just, like, had a booth director, or, like, you're talking about, like, when you auditioned for a project, the casting director would have you in and the casting director would direct you?
So I would not the it had nothing to do with, like, the casting directors or the people behind the auditions. This was just a studio. They had a little kind of thing where you, like, pay them a monthly fee and you get to go in, you know, a certain number of times a day or a month or whatever.
I thought that's what you were talking about. But I do know, some projects, especially if you get a call back, the director will bring you in.
No, that's a really good point. And yeah, sometimes you can have in-person callbacks and just in-person auditions anyway. No, that's a really good point. Fewer of those at the minute, or almost none of those.
Yeah, that's not happening.
hopefully, the Chris Pratt thing, this is a very dated reference for those of you in the future. Hopefully that stuff will come back.
Everyone's what are studios? Everyone's what is that?
Oh, no, please.
No, just kidding. To any deities listening, we are joking.
I used to go to a studio, and basically when the pandemic happened, I started having to record auditions on my own. So obviously there's the engineering aspect of things, like technologically getting things correct, but then also just recording them on your own, being your own judge, not having someone being oh, that was good, but try this, or that was kind of no one to just kind of that outside, unbiased, kind of purely totally objective kind of opinion. I'd kind of been auditioning for a few weeks and just worried about how I was doing and stuff. But I remember I really liked the Chongyun audition and I felt like I did a good job with it. But again, because I was not used to directing myself and everything, I was just kind of I think that was good. But I really like this character and I think this is really cool. And it kind of came along at a really good time and it just sort of, it really helped me and saved me. And, is that Remy?
Sorry, that is Remy. This little howler monkey. Sorry.
Oh, Remy. it was just this perfect, wonderful thing, and I had so much fun doing it. And I didn't know if there'd be any more when I recorded those first sessions, but then there did turn out to be more, and I've come back multiple times since and everything, including for this hangout, which was such an amazing way to start this year. I really love it. And I just love Chongyun because I just see so much of myself in him and everything.
Tell us, one of the things that I love that, resonates with me when I'm auditioning for, characters, but especially I feel like when we perform as a character, no matter how different they are from us, part of acting is finding pieces of yourself in that character, of saying this resonates with me, or finding where you connect with the character in a specific way. So I think that's one of the best parts of acting, is that you get to play all these different characters, but inside each of them is something that you feel calls to you or resonates with you. I think that's what makes when you are voicing a character, that's what really makes it sparkle and special, is when you're able to find that thing that's that resonates inside of you. So for Chongyun, what is the thing that you're this feels like me, or this resonates with me?
Some of these we'll perhaps get into as we do bits of the quest, because there are some things that are I'll tell you what, we'll hold this for later. This for later, just because, but please don't let us get to the end of the stream and we're like, oh wait, we forgot to
I will not forget. I will keep us after. We will stay.
We'll see if during the first path or two, however much we do today, we'll see what kind of comes up depending on what sort of branches you take. And we'll kind of see. Because one of the things, I'll say this now, there are some things about Chongyun where I feel like my Britishness really helps. And I know that sounds really weird. And again,
I don't know what you're talking about, but just of what I know of Chongyun already, I'm kind of wait, I think I can see that. So I'm excited to see now with the hangout, I'm excited. I'm really excited.
So there are just certain things, because even though we both sort of speak the same language, although I know this sounds weird, and I won't go on to a big England, UK versus America thing or whatever, but I think people who don't really know either country or just know one of the countries can think that they're kind of similar. And when you've kind of lived in one place or the other, or yeah. started to spend a lot of time with one place or the other, or even just with other people from those other countries, you kind of learn that, like, they're not really that similar. And even, like, the language, even though people say, oh, it's, like, the same language, it's, like, it's kind of the same, because it's just, like, there are so many words that are different here. Like, everything has a different name here.
Oh, so it's, like... no, it's, like, it is the same language, but it's, like, but it's not the same culture. And so yeah. I think, like, that's why some words are different, because, like, there are... It's the same, like, base language, but definitely two very different places.
Yeah.
I'm going to get started going towards there, but we're obviously still going to chat. Also, yeah, Teresa super chatted and said, hi to both of us. And, Teresa said, I wanted to say I love watching your videos. They brighten my day, and I hope you and Beau have lots of fun. Also, hi, Beau.
Hi, Teresa. If that is, unless there's like two Teresas, I'm pretty sure I know which Teresa that is. Hi, Teresa. Thank you so much for joining in and coming to see us.
Wait.
That's really lovely.
Okay. Wait. Oh, there it is. I was like, where am I going? Okay, now I know.
Okay. Can I just ask, am I supposed to be able to see anything?
No. Unless you want to watch the stream live.
No, I don't mind, and I can do that. If there are some points where I'm like, oh crud, I can't remember which part this is, then I'll find the picture. But I just wanted to check, because again, like going back to Karina, I think with Karina we sort of started, and I was like, am I supposed to see anything? And it's like, yes, I forgot to press the button. Like, so.
Oh yeah, I did that the last time I had someone on, and I did that. I felt like the stream was like more laggy.
No worries.
I'm not doing that.
No worries. I knew that. Again, I knew that there could be method to that. But I just wanted to check. I didn't want to not say anything. And then in like half an hour, I'd be like, Bo, it's right there on the screen. And it's like,
Bo, you need to know.
No, it's not.
When Zach was on the stream with me and we were doing the We Are Reunited quest. First of all, everyone told me, like, oh, you'll get through it in no time. Like, I did part of the quest before he came on my stream. So that I thinking, like, oh, we can get through this in 2 hours. And then I literally, there was a ruin guard, ruin hunter that I was fighting that I literally fought 5 different times. And Zach, I didn't share my screen with Zach. So Zach was like, I was like, Zach, what do I do? And he was like, I can't see this live. There is a delay for me. I was like, Zach, tell me what to do. And he was like, I'm trying, but there's a delay. It was so funny. So yeah. Aww. Anyway. Amelia super chatted and said, also, perfect time for another Who Tell Me Tell song. I don't know what that means. But
I can either do that now or later. That was a thing I did on Karina's stream, I believe.
You know what? Follow your heart and do what feels right to you.
I guess I'll do it now before my voice gets like dried out and tired in like 5 minutes. Okay, so I have to preface this just for people, because again, it's just if I start talking, if I just do this, it makes no sense. But I think there was a question on one of the streams ages ago. I think it might have been Chris's, but it was kind of about, like, oh, what Genshin, you know, what songs would you associate with which Genshin characters? And if you have any, Sarah, like, feel free to, you know, chip in or whatever. But oh, I think, you know, those kind of, you know, what songs would you pair up with what characters or whatever? I'm not a big enough music nerd or anything. I really, like, I enjoy listening to music. But it's not like a hobby, it's not something I actively do, and I know the names of no songs or bands, or if I do know the name of a band, I won't know their songs, and if I do know the name of a song, I won't know it's a band, and then I'll find out that, like, a song that I've liked, like a really super mainstream song, right, it'll be by someone, like, who's, like, really big, or whatever.
And you'll be like, have you ever heard of this song? And it's like a song, it's like the most famous song on the planet.
I never asked that question because I'm aware that the answer is probably like, yes, of course.
You're like, I just discovered this song. It's like the Beatles.
No, exactly. The Beatles are a really good example of like just this just like huge gap in my knowledge I had for ages. And I'm sort of better with it now. But yeah, they were one where like Money Can't Buy Me Love. I didn't know.
I just heard this song. It's so good. It's really indie. It's called Hey Jude. I don't know.
No, yeah, no, like, Money Can't Buy Me Love was, like, in an episode of The Simpsons, so I kind of knew this song for years, didn't know it was a Beatles.
So you were like, that song from The Simpsons!
Yeah, exactly. I was like, that song from, like, the old people montage in The Simpsons. Like, that's, you know, it's like, no, that's like a really, fit, that's like a well-known
like,
Beatles
no,
song.
No, that's a Beatles song. You're like, no, it's from The Simpsons.
Actually, Hey Jude, so whilst you're on this path, there's we're going to be going on multiple branches in both the game and just with my conversation
with
topic.
Us chatting. This is how I talk anyway, so this is perfect.
You know, I am such a waffler. Again, and going back to The Simpsons, like, there's a line in The Simpsons from an episode that, like, Ricky Gervais was credited with writing, and he just kind of, like, waffles in a very kind of, like, British way. And then there's a great Homer line where he goes, like, you take forever to say nothing. And I was like, that quote embodies me perfectly. So I say that one a lot. So there's a, like, Hey Jude, it's funny that there's a UK, there's like a charity in the UK, they have a telethon like every year called Children in Need. You may even remember when we did the picnic, I was wearing like a yellow shirt with like a bear on it. That bear is the mascot of this charity.
Okay.
And they did this really cool like music video years ago where they got like loads of different like cartoon characters and animated characters and stuff all together in like one music video to sing Hey Jude. It had like a load of like British characters and stuff, so like Fireman Sam and whoever, and this is all probably very like niche if you. But Shaggy from Scooby-Doo appeared in it and stuff and they had like Cartoon Network characters and other things, so they had like loads of different like cartoon characters from all different just walks of animation, different decades and stuff, come together, and they're all like animated into one music video singing Hey Jude, and it was a charity, and they sold the song, and it, you know. They got like original voices for the characters and stuff like that. And so it was really cool. But again, it's not that I am like, oh wow, they just invented this song. I knew it was like a song. Like, I knew it was obviously a famous song, but I didn't know it was a Beatles song. So when I think of Hey Jude, I mean, I do know it's a Beatles song, but I'm like, oh, the cartoon charity song kind of thing.
Oh,
that's how I think of
You're
it in my head.
So funny. Okay, well, now I want to hear the song. I want to hear you sing Who Tell Me Tell.
I almost forgot why I was talking about cartoon charity.
Now you've like, you've made me right. So curious.
So we're thinking of songs and whatever, and I think maybe with like Chongyun, we just kind of were like, thought of something like You're As Cold As Ice, something like that. Or Ice Baby, maybe.
Okay.
But the Hu Tao thing, Brie did a TikTok, I think, or something, ages ago, where she like, it was kind of like a who's on first kind of joke almost. It was like, Hu Tao, me Tao, like I'm Tao or something like that. Sort of silly little open punchline to this TikTok, right? So I was kind of like, Hu Tao, me Tao, 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 Hu Tao, me Tao. And I started thinking of that. This is how my brain works. This is how insane I am.
Okay.
If you can't already tell from the like 10 minutes we've been talking, if you haven't realized, this is now the point where it's like, oh, he's crazy.
Beau! You have to say it in a nice way.
Who tell me tell? I'm nuts. Nuts, mental, bonkers. take your pick. Mental is like the British one. Like, oh, I'm mental. Who tell me tell? So I was kind of thinking of that. And then, whenever I see Hu Tao, the song that starts playing in my head, I start thinking like, Hu Tao me tell, Hu Tao me tell, Hu Tao me tell, Hu Tao me tell. I can't help this feeling. Hu Tao me tell, Hu Tao me tell. Deep inside of me. So I think of that song, which again, I think of as like the Guardians of the Galaxy song. I always think of something as the like television / movie / commercial.
That was so good.
So So there you go. So that's the song I think about whenever I see Hu Tao. Because of a TikTok that Bree did. Again, this is like my mind get like from like A to B to C to D to blah blah blah. But if I just
no.
if you said what's the Hu Tao song and I go Hu Tao Hu Tao Hu Tao, you would have just thought what?
I'd be like, well, honestly, I actually probably would have like made up my own justification for it. That's how my brain works. I would have gone on a whole like spiraling tangent of like, okay, I think how Bo got there is so. That's amazing. We also did get two more super chats. Brooklyn says, "Hi Sarah and Bo, love you both so much." Hi, Brooklyn. And then Reb says, "It's best boy time." So I'm doing some finger guns for best boy. Okay. So I guess we'll get started on this. Let's see. Poor Chongyun has just been standing there, and we've been like, you know, in the Western movies when it's like. But it's like, they're standing on like either sides of the one lane road, and there's like a cuckoo, like with nothing else. It's like it's just like wind, and then like cuckoo,
and a screech or something. Yeah.
Yeah, and it looks like they're about to like. Yes, exactly. It looks like they're about to like draw, do like a shoot off. Oh, someone should definitely draw that for us. Tag us on Twitter. Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
Hello, Chongyun. Okay, let's say hi to him.
Okay. Masuki, if you're out there, Masuki drew some really cool little bits of art after one of my signing streams.
Aww.
So Masuki Inc, if you're listening,
you're
like,
here.
Like get on that Western drawing.
This is your time.
This is your moment to shine.
This is your time.
No, I am kidding. Like no pressure. Like
we will retweet it. We will retweet it. Or I will. I'm not gonna promise what Bo.
I'm taking over
Bo's.
Anyway, sorry. Yeah, no, make Chongyun do something, please.
Okay, here we go. Here we go.
poor Chongyun.
Ah, well, he's fine. He's okay. He's doing fine.
Excuse me. Have you perchance seen any evil spirits?
Evil spirits?
Oh, my apologies. You're not from around here, are you? This question must sound a little confusing to you. I'm Chongyun, a local exorcist from Liyue. Those versed in the arts of exorcism refer to all forms of demons and monsters as evil spirits. Evil spirits have existed since ancient times. They lurk among the shadows in the land of Liyue, stirring up all sorts of trouble and mischief. It is my duty to exorcise or destroy them, and protect the citizens here from their evil doings.
Okay, so we have three options. Is there one is that is an admirable job, one is that sounds similar to the works of adventurers, and the other one is I get it. That's what the vigilant Yaksha fights against, right? Is there one that you want us to do?
So basically, like, I'd say two of those are, like, definitely good ones, I would say. I kind of think of them as, like ones that will make him happy and ones that will make him sad or something like that. And not that, like, two of those will make him happy, one will make him sad, but there are two there which are, like, I would say are good ones.
Okay, so I should choose that's an admirable job, right?
Yeah, go for that. Okay. I mean, this is your quest. This is your quest.
Well, I know, but I want to do one that's going to be, you know, I want it to be fun. Okay, here we go. We're going to do, that is an admirable job.
It's work that must be done.
Boost is
much like any other job. That's all. Sorry, I digress. Judging from your response, it seems you aren't well versed in the realm of evil spirits. But that's understandable. If I may ask, have you happened to come across anything strange recently? Sometimes even the most trivial matters prove helpful in my hunt for evil spirits.
Nothing in particular.
Oh, I see. Well, fair enough. In that case, I guess I'll just have to try my luck with the clues I already have.
What clues do you have now?
Only some scattered reports, really. Nothing too significant yet. But if you're interested, I can tell you about some of the more useful ones I've gathered so far. I read a flyer that said, the test of courage is now being held on Wu Wong Hill. Bring your best friend and test your courage together. Then, recently, the sounds of footsteps and shouting have been heard outside people's windows at night. The noises have frightened the children and they are unable to sleep. And a huge shadow has appeared in Guili Plains. It flies and swirls, summons down fireballs, and makes all sorts of strange noises. Cases such as these might actually be worth our attention.
Okay, we've got the test of courage. Oh, then there's one where the traveler just completely dismisses him. Then one where the shadow looks like it could be a ruin hunter. What do you think? Test of courage or shadow in the other?
Why actually is, like, the text on the other one, like, the dismissive one?
The dismissive one is sometimes drunkards pass by people's windows at night. That's nothing unusual.
Oh, yeah. let's go with the shadow one.
Okay, I don't know how to pronounce this word. Is it Julie?
Gwaili.
Gwaili!
Gwaili
Pang? I did know that. Isn't it? No, that's Guizhong Ballista. Y'all, reading is hard. Okay, so we're going to do... the shadow in Gwaili Plains sounds like it may be a ruin hunter.
Ruin hunter? That would fit the description. But why has no one recognized it? Do you think I'm not deciphering these clues correctly?
Oh. Okay, I'm gonna choose the nice version. I'm gonna choose the one where I'm not telling Chongyun that he's making things up.
Yeah, no, I will just say, there is, like, generally a bit of a theme, I feel like, where one of them is kind of
being rude.
Yeah, no, that is the thing. Like, there's usually one, like, so often there's one where it's like, I agree, or that sounds like it makes sense, or like, yeah, let's do that.
And then the other way it's like,
you're crazy, or like that's
absolutely
stupid.
Not.
Or like, it's just this really simple, stupid little thing. Why are you making, like, yeah. So, I will just say it was funny, because when I did it with Zach, there were some things where he was like, I don't know which one to pick, and I was looking at them being like,
you're like,
I feel
one
like
is nice
is like,
and one is like, not.
Yeah, like for me, I was kind of like, I feel like one of these is clearly different from the others, but he like didn't know which one. But I guess it's just because I know, but I think part of that is just I know Chongyun and, you know. And all
and
this
you
other
also
stuff.
Know like what the endings are.
Yeah, exactly. So I was kind of like, you know, I think that's more me than anything, just me having the advantage.
Okay, so I'm going to choose, although they all seem far-fetched, I better not tell him that. He seems like quite the persistent character.
I think the clue about the test of courage is the most relevant one I have so far. If strange things have been happening at the event, then evil spirits may well be the cause. But there's an unusual requirement for this event. You must be a team of two people in order to participate.
Okay, I'm gonna choose... Okay, it says there has to be a team, so I'm gonna say... One is actually that's quite normal, and then one is the aim is to strengthen the relationship between the two participants. I'm going to choose that one, I think, because this is a hangout. We're supposed to be becoming BFFs. Okay. The aim is to strengthen the relationship between the two participants.
Huh? Strengthen the relationship? Sorry, I don't really get it.
Chongyun's like, I don't get it.
If you have
what do you mean?
Could you join me for this event?
Chongyun's like, I don't understand friendship.
Good eye for
no, he kind of doesn't. He had like a very sort of like isolated.
I'm sure we'll track down those evil spirits.
Chongyun. Okay, I'm gonna say, okay, I'm free now anyway.
Thank you. I was starting to worry that I wouldn't be able to find a partner. We should make haste. If there are evil spirits at the event, then things could get dangerous.
Things could get dangerous. All right, so now we're gonna go to this event. This is very exciting.
It is exciting.
Also, we did see a super chat that I missed. It said it was from Dan Yem. Said hello from 5 a.m. land. I'm impatiently waiting for my Beau print, which is the first print I've ever purchased, and a smiley face. Yay! And
oh, well,
also,
I hope you get it soon.
You're doing another signing.
Yeah. So I'm aiming for like the. It should hopefully be on like the second again. If you're listening in the future, this is like irrelevant. But yeah, if you're listening like live now, I think I'm sort of aiming to do it on like the 13th of November. So that's like the Saturday of the second weekend in November.
Yeah. So the signing is the first and second weekends. The general Genshin Impact Fall signing is the second and third weekends of November and their respective weeks. Sorry, I just had to get...
Yeah, no, you're good.
I got a Geoculus because I saw it and I just had to. Anyway, moving on. So, you're doing it, you said, the Saturday...
of the second weekend.
Second weekend.
Like, I might, like, leave the store open during it and for a bit afterwards and like do like a mini sort of spillover, like extra bonus one, like the following weekend, just to give people like an extra chance. I know sometimes people sort of watch the streams and then they like get FOMO and then like, oh no, I want one.
Well, so it's always good to like keep your shop open during the signings too, because, you know, like sometimes people like miss the announcement and they don't like realize it until it like comes on, you know, especially if the algorithm sent your stream their way. Where will you be streaming?
In my Instagram, which is, I think, is it like Beau Bridgland? I don't even remember my own Instagram.
It should be on the description of this video. I put your socials.
Oh, fantastic. Okay,
so it should be there. If it's not, someone say in the chat and I'll add it.
Check the description because I'm probably wrong.
Okay, so we're going to go do this thing. I think we have to fight somebody.
Ooh.
Okay, let's go talk to this person. Hello.
Please be careful, everyone. Pay close attention to your surroundings.
I feel like we're gonna get struck by lightning. It's starting to rain again. That's fine.
Don't get separated from your partner and wander off on your own. You'll most certainly be in for a scare if you go alone.
Did you hear that? He's warning the event participants. Maybe something strange really did happen here. Let's investigate.
I think you misunderstood that.
Welcome to the test of courage. You two must be very close friends.
Actually, we just met.
No problem at all. Don't be shy. Just enjoy yourselves. But please drink this before you enter the test of courage.
Okay, we're drinking.
This drink
something?
Will boost the yang energy inside your body and lift your courage.
Ooh.
Not only that, but this drink will also allow you to see things which are usually hidden from the naked eye. Pretty exciting, huh?
Yang energy?
That's right. Ghosts are said to be full of yin energy, so more yang energy will surely deter them.
Oh, I've never heard of such a drink. Is it a secret recipe? Or maybe some kind of potion?
Okay, so our options are, perhaps it's all psychological, and the other one is, I think you might have misunderstood this whole test of courage thing. So, we're gonna go with the first one.
Yeah.
I feel like some of these are just, like, rude, like... Not nice. Okay, so we're gonna go with perhaps it's all just psychological.
Possibly. But why bother exaggerating it so much then? But if this drink really does boost yang energy, then it's potentially dangerous for me.
Dangerous?
You see, I have a very rare constitution called a pure yang spirit.
Ooh.
Such a constitution allows me to scare away evil spirits. But it also makes me prone to emotional impulses.
You seem like a very calm person to me.
I am constantly focusing to keep my mind and body in a normal state, which usually works until I suffer from some external stress.
Come now, what's with that serious expression on your face, lad? You aren't worried about the drink, are you? It's delicious and quite effective, if I do say so myself. There's nothing to worry about. Or if you're still unsure, perhaps only one of you could take the drink. The person who takes the drink can protect the one who doesn't. It'll be exciting either way.
It's hard to refuse when you put it that way.
I'm gonna say... Oh, I don't know. Okay, the options are that we both drink this drink that you're worried will hurt you, or that just I drink it alone.
I will just, before I answer that question, I will just say, next time there's, like, a break, not right now, but next time you, like, have to go off and, like, talk to someone or fight something, I'll kind of at least preliminarily answer the what do I like about Chongyun or what do I see about
myself. Yes.
Because there have been a couple of things already, and I don't want to forget them. So here... My thinking would be, if I were playing and I, like, didn't voice Chongyun or something, I'd be like, he seems kind of, like, reserved about the idea of, like, having it. So I wouldn't want him to have any at all.
Okay, so we're gonna go, I'll drink it alone.
Yeah, so that's what I would go with.
Okay, I'm gonna say, just let me drink it alone.
All right, here it is. Please drink it slowly. Yes, that's it. You did great. You two may enter now.
Okay, so we are at a pausing place before you Tell us what you like. Someone did super chat and they said, you guys are awesome. Here, have one bowl of chicken soup each. And then there's like a little bowl emoji. Lots of love and have a nice day. Thank you for the soup.
Oh, thank you. one of the things, just because, going off, he seems persistent, and it's, that's something that I'm, a very determined person. I wouldn't be here pursuing my dreams of a voiceover if I weren't. Trust me on that one. And so that's definitely a thing. But, yeah, Chongyun's, a very kind of, hardworking and sort of focused person, and I like to think of myself that way. I know perhaps that seems hard to believe when I'm so I did this thing, and then I listened, or whatever. And then, because the other thing I was going to say is, he seems like a very calm person, and generally I do like to think of myself as a calm person. Again, I know it's okay, so there's this animated music video, and it was of a Beatles song, but I didn't know it was a Beatles song. You wouldn't,
But, okay,
but normally.
Literally the entire chat, the second you got here, was like, wow, Beau's voice, this is so soothing. all this stuff. So I think even when you're feeling your most energetic, you're still a very I don't know, centered person. You're centered and self-aware. And
can I just say, that's the thing about Chongyun. Chongyun kind of has things where he kind of there'll be things later on where he'll kind of be oh, sorry, I'm being really something. And then it's he's not being the something at all. Kind of thing. Oh my gosh, I'm being and it's what? No, you're not. And that's kind of what I'm oh my gosh, I'm being so rude. And it's no, you're being very polite or something. You're very...
I know, you're over here being I've been so energetic, I've been so loud. And I'm literally I had to put a limiter on my mic for how loud I scream.
Right, and but so that's kind of a thing where Chongyun and I are very similar, and it's something I kind of like about him. I like that he kind of is, and then another thing as well, I'll just sort of touch on this. Another interesting thing about him is he's very sort of devoted to his, sort of fighting evil spirits and stuff like that, and his thaumaturgy and all that, So he's very sort of focused on that, but he's kind of just spent a lot of his life just kind of training for that and stuff, and he's kind of not really had a lot of human interaction in a way. I don't mean he's a feral child or something, but I just mean he's just kind of gone off and kind of lived a very kind of isolated life in some ways.
So I don't know why.
So there'll be all these things where he kind of misses for us would be kind of normal social cues, because he just kind of doesn't know how to person sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes people don't know how to people, and that's fair. But yeah, I can see that about him. He's oh, we're friends? And you're I just agreed to... why would I agree to come here with you if I didn't want to be your friend?
Right, exactly. Yeah, so totally.
So, yes. Okay, so let's go towards this thing. I drink the drink. This is very creepy. Someone said your voice is soothing because you're British, but I think your voice is soothing just in general. Because Chongyun's voice is also very soothing.
Thank you. I have a lot of comments about that and stuff. That is a thing that people have just either me or me when I'm in character. Yeah, this sort of nice calming presence.
I also have a really good British accent. No, I'm just kidding. And by really good, I mean I do this horrible British accent sometimes on stream. It's so bad. It's so bad. And then one time, Karina, who was it? On the Among Us stream, somebody did an accent that was maybe British, and Karina was like, that was horrible. And we were all like, Karina, you can't call someone's accent horrible. It was so funny. Chongyun says this.
They could all be in grave danger if there really is an evil spirit here. We must get to the bottom of this. I'm not too sure where we should start, but I know we'll find something once we start looking. These innocent participants are completely oblivious to the potential danger here. We'll need to protect them.
The test of courage isn't actually dangerous, you know.
What? please.
See, can I just say little things like the, you know, like that kind of adds like a rudeness to it, you know? Like, do you know what I mean? Like, if you were just saying like, oh, I don't think the test of courage is dangerous. That's one thing.
But that would have been nice.
A test of courage isn't dangerous, you know.
You know.
It's just like...
It's funny like, that, because like for that one, like there was only one choice. So they
were
just like,
yeah,
they were just like that, the traveler really, is gonna be sassy.
Two things, yeah. One, yeah, sometimes there are bits where there's just like one option, and it's like, I don't want to say that, but I do just find it funny when there are things in games. Genshin's one, I found it in like Fire Emblem. For people who've like followed me on Twitter throughout the year, they know I've played Fire Emblem Three Houses a bunch of times. And sometimes in like the support conversations on that, there are bits where it's like, you'll get like two options, and it's like, I don't like either of
these. These are both rude. Stop trying to make me be rude.
I'm sorry if I interrupted anything.
No, it's fine. Like this, the hangout is flexible. We can pause never. Also, someone said, that Karina is so funny. And yes, when I was saying that about the Among Us stream, I was meaning it in the sense that it was like such a funny part. Last Among Us stream, Karina was so like, so savage. It was so funny. Karina would be like, I'm booting you off because of this. And it would be something like not anything to do with the game. It was hilarious.
Yeah.
For those who haven't ever seen one of Karina's streams, go watch Karina Becker. They are the English voice of Paimon. They are so funny and amazing, and their streams are awesome. Okay. Okay, so we're going to choose this. The two options are the participants are here to just have fun, and you're taking this event too seriously, and we're going to choose the first one because the second one is rude.
Yep, exactly. Thank you.
We're going to choose... the participants are just here to have fun.
You mean being scared is like entertainment to them? I see.
This is the bit where SpongeBob and Plankton join Chongyun and sing the fun song. The F is for, like, F is for friends who do stuff together.
Wait, that would be amazing though. That would be so good. Okay. Let's see. Okay, Chongyun's like, I don't understand.
He does, yeah.
Losing control. So I rarely have
Chongyun is
for
the plankton of
this. I'm completely unfamiliar with what others would consider entertainment.
I see.
Well, either way, let's check the area for any evil spirits just in case. Where should we start?
Oh. Whew, where should we start? Okay, we're gonna go look for these evil spirits. Xander said, why you gotta be so rude? Yep, I appreciate it. Let's see what else. Oh yeah, well, sometimes I accidentally... Okay, so mini side tangent. Have you ever played Breath of the Wild?
No, I'm gonna be getting it / playing it this Christmas. Because
awesome.
I've wanted to play it for ages. I was always hoping, because I have a Switch Lite. Sorry, this is where I go off on a tangent.
Wait! Oh, yeah, no, it's on the Switch. I was going to be like, wait, it's on the Switch. No, it is. It is. No, that's how I played it.
So I do have a Switch, but I only have a Switch Lite, and I was always hoping I'd get, like, a regular Switch, or, like, now I really want, like, the Switch OLED. And like, play it on a television, but I was just like, I can't wait any longer for Breath of the Wild. I need to play it, so I'm getting it this Christmas. I'm very much looking forward to that. But anyway, so go on about, so don't spoil anything if there's anything, like, really spoilery.
This is not spoiling anything. Here's the thing, though, about Breath of the Wild. It's open world like Genshin.
Yeah.
But in Genshin, like, you can press L3 and it tells you where you should be going, like, there was a part where someone was, like, talking to me or talking to Link, and then was, like, there were two options, and it was, like, oh, you could go here. That would be really helpful. And I was just, like, oh, no. Because no was an option, you know? So I was, like, no. So then I'm, like, wandering around. I'm super lost. I call my brother, who's the one who was, like, you... Like, he loves that game, so he was like, he's the one that, like, told me to play. So I call him, like, what am I supposed to be doing? There's nothing to do. I'm so confused. And he was like, well, that person told you, like, what to do next. And I was like, oh, but I told them no. Like, I was like, oh, no, thanks. And then I left. And he was like, well, why would you say that? You have to, like, do that to keep going in the story. And I was like, well, then why is no an option? Okay? If picking no means I won't progress in the story, why is that even a choice?
Okay, that's actually really funny. Also, like, side note, Breath of the Wild apparently sounds like the ultimate improv teacher. Always say yes. Just say yes.
Well, yeah, but I was like, oh, like, I thought that was like a side thing. Like, I didn't think,
It's very, like, open world. Like, see, I one thing I do kind of find annoying about some games, and this was the thing I found a bit annoying about, like, A Legend of Zelda, A Link Between Worlds. Legend of Zelda, A Link Between Worlds, I think when I, like, read reviews and stuff, it kind of said stuff like, oh, you can, like, do dungeons in, like, any order or whatever, kind of, or some, you know, stuff. And maybe this was a little bit with, like, A Link to the Past, but I kind of hate it where, I don't mind things, like, not being linear, but it's, like, but I hate when things, like, act like they're not linear, but then they do have
but
some linearity.
But then they are, yeah.
Yeah, and so it's like, and with those games, there were bits where it's like, you can do the dungeons in any order, so I'd, like, stumble upon a dungeon, and then it's like, oh, you need an item. Oh, what item do I get? Oh, the one from, like, the second dungeon. Then I need to go to the second dungeon, don't
right.
I?
If I like, can't, I want to be use... told what order, like, true open world with, like, absolutely no guidance is not for me. I am not that good of a I'm, like, not a good gamer, so I can't. The amount of times I died falling off of a mountain, well, then why is it an option for me to try to climb the mountain if I'm gonna
right.
just die because it's cold? Like,
see,
like,
yeah.
No, I don't, rude.
Because a thing I hate just in gaming is just sort of, if, like, I do hate, like, if you're given, like, oh, do you go, like, left or right or up or down or whatever, and it's like, okay, there's nothing telling me one of these is good and one of these is bad.
How do I know?
And I hate kind of, but, like, when you start going down a path and then it's like, oh, you can't progress any further, or, like, or you suddenly stumble upon, like, really high leveled enemies or something like that, and it's like, well, then why, like, don't present these to me as if they're equal when they're very clearly not, like.
Like,
I feel like in
Genshin, as you level up, the world levels up. So there's not,
right.
like, when you first start playing, there's not anywhere that you can stumble where you're like, oh my gosh, like, I'm so under-leveled. Well, I say that,
I
had to fight a Ruin Hunter 5 times to beat it. So anyway, moving on. Some of us are just bad at games, regardless of how they're built. But I was very annoyed at Breath of the Wild. I was like, why is this mountain here? Why am I able to access this mountain if I am unable to climb it because it's too cold? Anyway, I can't wait for you to play Breath of the Wild and tell me what you think.
Yeah,
tell
definitely.
Me how you
me
feel
too.
About the open worldness.
You'll just get a random message in two months.
Perfect. That's what,
like,
I want.
This where I'm just like, I fell off this stupid mountain.
I literally cannot wait. I'm so excited for that.
Way
message.
To get that
suspect. Seriously, just leave me alone.
Oh, this person's yelling at us.
Why must
alone.
You be so obstinate? Calm down. It's not what you think.
No, don't even bother. You think I don't know what you're doing?
Stop. Not a step closer.
Oh, Chongyun!
I'll exercise it right now.
Exercise it?
What do you do?
Who are you? What are
he
you
was like, stop!
About?
Don't come any closer. Okay. All right, assertiveness. All right. That's the first time he's been like, I mean business. Okay.
Wait, what?
Oh, he was wrong. Okay, I'm going to say. Everyone, just calm down.
Oh, he's just a person? It seems I've made a mistake.
I will just say, like, there are so many quirky and funny bits in this story, and the random people you bump into are, like, all hilarious.
Chuck, you thought the dude was an evil spirit, but he's a person.
Excuse me? A tantrum? This is supposed to be a date, you know? And now that we're finally here, you don't want to go anywhere, and you just want to hang around the entrance. What's the point in that?
Whoa, this is a date gone bad.
Very bad.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm just a little bit scared, that's all. That's why I've been stalling.
Chongyun was like, I'll save you from this spirit. Oh, that's a person.
Let's take a moment to calm down.
Okay, I'm going to say Well, there's, they seem to be here to participate. And the other one is like, I think we're intruding on them. So I guess we'll do the first one.
Yeah, I'd agree with that.
They seem to be here to participate, just like everyone else.
I wasn't thinking clearly. It was pure impulse.
I'm sorry. Please, forgive me. Will you give me another chance?
Fine. I know I shouldn't have yelled at you.
Oh, it doesn't matter anymore. You're still the best, babe.
Who said you could call me babe? You're so annoying.
This couple is so...
So they really are on a date? But why in such a dangerous place like this? Perhaps we should just leave them alone.
Okay, so now we're gonna go to the second thing, the second evil spirit. Well, that's... I'm going away from the evil spirits. Okay. oh my gosh, that was funny. Although I was like, okay, Chongyun, like, so chill. Like, what is it? Chill as a cucumber?
Oh, cool as a cucumber, yeah. See, is that not an American phrase?
I'm just making up phrases now.
No, but like, is that like a British phrase, or
no.
Or did you just forget a phrase?
A universal phrase. No.
Because sometimes there are just phrases where I'll say them, and then.
No, that's a well-known American phrase. You should not use me as the litmus test of what is and isn't the correct way to say it, but from now on, it's chill as a cucumber. So anyway, Chongyun's normally so like cool and chill, and then that happened, and he was like, stop it! I'm gonna exercise the demon! Okay, here we go. Anywho, moving on. Just me.
This is all your fault. This place nearly scared me to death.
All right. Don't lose your temper. We're leaving now, okay? To think I used to believe you were brave.
Oh, these couples are
but
really...
But this is different.
Excuse me, but I couldn't help but overhear your conversation. Did you perchance encounter an evil spirit? If so, I'm here to track it. Could you please tell me which direction it went?
Who are you? No, I didn't see anything, so don't ask. So please just leave me alone. I don't know what you're talking about, and I certainly don't want anything to do with an evil spirit.
My apologies. Perhaps you misunderstood what I meant. I only wish to know what the spirit looks like, and which way it went so we could track it down. If you can't describe its appearance, then at least show us the way it went.
Show you the way? No, I'm not going anywhere.
Okay, you don't have to go anywhere.
We're not taking you anywhere.
Chongyun's like, I literally don't want you with us, so.
All right, that's enough. Listen, if you keep talking like that, she might actually end up believing in that nonsense. Can't you see she's terrified enough already? You could go find whatever strange things you're looking for on your own.
My apologies. I didn't mean to frighten her.
He's quite the serious exorcist.
Yes. I'm just trying to hunt the evil spirit you mentioned to prevent it from hurting anyone.
Isn't it a bit strange for an exorcist to come to the test of courage looking for evil spirits? Oh, I think I get it now. But we didn't say anything about a ghost or spirit. I think you misunderstood us. I brought my girlfriend here to have some fun, but instead she got frightened by all this spooky atmosphere. Now we'll just have to go home. I'm not too sure what you're looking for. But we did see some dark shadows making strange noises.
Thank you very much. That's very helpful.
It's actually not helpful at all.
Well, you heard it. It seems something unusual is going on here. But why would they ever want to come here if they get scared so easily?
The point isn't getting scared. It's relying on each other in the face of fear.
Interesting. I have never had any fear of evil spirits, so perhaps I'm unable to understand their feelings. It's amazing that you're able to pick up on that. Good thing I brought you as my partner. Anyway, let's keep searching the area.
Do we know why Chongyun has never feared evil spirits? Is it because he's just, like, always been an exorcist?
Yeah, I think it's basically just kind of that. He's sort of spent, like, his whole life just kind of, like, training to sort of be an exorcist slash training in exorcism.
So he's not, like, scared of the evil,
No,
the
not
evil spirits, because he's like, this is what he spent his life doing.
Yeah, he's just very determined to kind of, like, take them down and
Also, that couple was not helpful at all. Chongyun was like, where's the evil spirit? And they were like, we're not gonna go with you. And Chongyun's like, well, first of all, I didn't ask you to go with us.
Yeah,
and then,
I know them.
Like, why didn't she just point in the direction?
They're funny. Like they're funny. They're funny, ha-ha funny. And then they're funny as in, like, sort of weird.
Okay, so we found some strange smoke.
These are traces left by
this is perfect
spirit.
To do at, like,
no doubt about it.
Fall time. Yeah.
So there are only two possibilities.
Yeah, again, for those of you in the future who, like, don't know Chris Pratt memes and stuff, so we're recording this a few days after.
This is November 4th, 2021, just in case. Okay, I'm gonna say, pronunciations are not my forte. I'm assuming it's Wuwong Hill, right?
Yeah, Wuwong Hill, yeah.
Oh my gosh, you're perfect. Okay. You have to be on every stream so you can tell me how to say things. Okay. I'm going to say...
I just know the things I say. I don't know. Like
I know. That's the thing. Me too. But the traveler doesn't like say every location. So I'm like, if somebody thinks like I haven't said, I don't think.
Because sometimes I'll see like some of the other characters' names and I'll just call them by their voice actor.
Yeah, you're
thing.
Like...
Kaylee's character and Jack's character.
Okay, so I'm going to say... Are evil spirits the reason why Wuwong Hill is so gloomy all the time?
No, I don't think so. There have been many rumors regarding the cause of Wuwong Hill's gloomy aura, but nothing is certain. Although, once it became the murky place you see now, it also began to attract more evil spirits. Anyway, these traces lead us one step closer to finding an evil spirit.
So excited to find this evil spirit! Oh. Okay, proceed onward. Okay.
Well, at least we've found some useful clues. We'll need to keep searching further in. But to avoid alerting the evil spirit, perhaps I should wait here.
You're not coming?
When we were collecting clues just now, we were still unsure whether any evil spirit is actually here or not. But now that possibility seems higher, it would be wise to proceed more cautiously. Our efforts will be wasted if my yang energy scares the evil spirit away. Besides, I trust your capability and experience as an adventurer. If you come across a powerful demon, I'll get there as fast as possible.
Just wait for my word.
All right. Thank you.
Okay, so now we're continuing on without... Chongyun.
Yeah, so I don't really know how much he explained there or not. I think he may have explained a little bit. But yeah, that's it. Kind of even so, that kind of like touches on like I guess like the lore of Chongyun a bit.
Okay.
But basically, yeah, Chongyun. So in addition to sort of like being trained as an exorcist and stuff, he's like, he has a pure yang spirit.
Yeah, so he said which is why he couldn't take the drink.
Yeah, and that doesn't mean that he tried to run for the Democratic candidate as president and then as New York governor and everything. That means that, very specific, like, 2021 and 2020 jokes there. And like, politics as well. Like, that's why everyone's here for, like, the
okay,
for the US.
Okay, I don't even understand that joke. I don't even get that joke. You have to explain it.
Sorry, Yang's spirit, like, Andrew Yang, if you remember him, the guy who... The universal income guy. I could have said a universal income joke. Anyway,
get it. That's funny.
Anyway, so the pure yang spirit. So yeah, there's like the yin and yang. And
right.
Chongyun is kind of like overflowing with yang energy. And like ghosts and spirits and demons and everything do not like yang energy and will kind of run away from it. And so... if, like, Chongyun gets, like, close to a spirit, they can, like, sense him coming and just kind of run off because they hate it so much kind of thing.
Yeah.
So that's kind of, like, a little bit more of an explanation as to, why you're
going
alone.
Like, why he couldn't come along. Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, if I come, they'll know I'm coming and blah, blah, blah. And so, but also as well, and then maybe we'll get to it later or whatever as well, but then also... you know, there's a lot of like stuff to do with like hot and cold and like Chongyun's popsicles, and that all kind of plays into this as well. And
oh yeah, I kind of remember when it was the Moon Chase Festival, like Xiangling is like going around asking everyone like what their favorite recipes are and like what they look for in a favorite recipe, and Chongyun and Singcho are together when we like go during part of that like festival, and then I think Chongyun said like that he only eats cold things.
Yeah, like cold things and very like sort of plain things.
Yes, like
as well.
Not anything very spicy or anything like that.
Yeah, so like Yang is very associated with like sort of like spice and heat and sort of there's like a whole kind of thing in Eastern culture about like hot and cold and stuff like that, and then the yin is like the sort of cold stuff. So Chongyun kind of, because he has this like kind of abundance of like the hot, he kind of balances it out with like cold and plain stuff, and is basically just kind of so it's why again sort of just I suppose it's a bit more of like an in reference between us than for the audience and stuff, but you know when we like say did the like picnic with everyone earlier this year, and we were like, oh, we should have like foods based on our characters, and I was like, my character literally has like almost like frozen water popsicles.
Yeah,
because it's just it's like no flavor popsicles kind of thing. So again, because of this kind of like balancing of his energy and stuff. So
okay,
so I was like, I'm gonna bake a cake.
well, that was of course the right decision. I guess the question is, do you, Beau, like super spicy food, or do you prefer not so spicy food? I'm saying, do you like plain water? But I mean, like, are you a person that you just like regular amount of spice, or do you like?
Okay, first
really start.
I actually really do love water. I drink a lot of it. I do like my water.
so but, this is actually an advertisement for drinking water. Everybody, yes. Drink water.
Yeah, drink. Hang on.
We're drinking our water.
There we go. So I've actually been pretty good in remembering to do it today. But anyway. But no, I was gonna say. So I can like. I can tolerate spice or like some spice or whatever, and sometimes it's nice. Like there are like some dishes and foods where I won't go into a whole thing here, but basically, so I can tolerate some spice, but just I prefer like mild things myself, and I like mild things. But it was weird, like, because for me, and I mean this is like the thing, like spice isn't a flavor, like heat isn't a flavor, it's a sensation. Like you know, like when people are like, oh, I'm gonna like have these like ghost chili whatevers kind of thing. It's like you're not adding like a flavor, you're just adding heat, and that's just like a sensation. Like you're not making it more delicious,
right?
You're just adding more of a sensation, and that sensation is like deemed an unpleasant one as well, which is kind of nuts.
It's so funny you say that though, because like I'm a person where I'm like, I also like, I like spicy food, but I can't eat like too much of it. Like I couldn't like,
right.
I couldn't get like a super spicy like Thai dish and then like put like hot sauce on it. Cause then like my like lips would probably swell. So like I couldn't do that. But like my brother and his friends, like they're people that they're just like, they love it. And they like hot things too. So they're like, they'll put like the like habanero sauce or whatever the hot sauce is, they'll like put that on things that to me are already like spicy and hot, like they're just piling it on, they love it. So I'm like, some people just, they love it.
So yeah, so I'm not a spice fiend, but I for like the past few years I have kind of realized that there are some dishes where just weirdly like a bit of spice is really welcome. I remember my mom got this cook, and again, this isn't a long story, but my mom got this cookbook and she made this dish, and it was like this really delicious, like chicken paprika thing. And it was really delicious, but it was so weird. It was so weird having it. It was like really tasty, and it was just missing something. And it had all these like flavors where, in a way, like your body and your tongue was almost like expecting just a little bit of like a heat to it, but there was nothing. It was like completely mild, like not even a hint.
So you were like
something's
missing.
And it was the strangest thing. My mom was like, oh, this needs some like spice to it, some heat. And in my head, I started going down my like, spot, like heat is just a, what was I even saying? Heat is just a sensation, not a, you know, and but then I like had it and I was like, dang it, this is like really delicious, but it is missing like some heat to it. So ever since then, I always used to just think people were mad for like wanting to like add spice to things. But ever since then, I've kind of realized that there are some dishes and things where like a little bit of like a heat to it is like actually a nice thing. And I don't know, it's weird. Like it almost is like a flavor or whatever, but there's a point.
Yeah.
There's a point where it's like, no, now you're just trying to like make yourself cry or like, or just like watery tears or to, you know, like just sort of like hurt your intestines or, you know, like whatever. You know,
I find it so fascinating that like we all have like people have different taste buds. Not like,
yeah,
in the sense of like, I find it so fascinating that like I'll have something that I'm like, oh, this is super sour. And then my friend will be like, that's not very sour at all. And I'm like, how are you not experiencing what I'm experiencing? So I always like find it super fascinating that like, I don't know. Like, that's the other thing. I've sworn off of them. I can no longer have them. But I used to really like Flaming Hot Cheetos. And not only are they, like, actively so bad for you. So bad. They're, like, burning your insides. But I, like, loved them. And then I had a friend who would be like, I can't even have one Flaming Hot Cheeto. If I have one Flaming Hot Cheeto, my mouth is, like, burning. And I was just like, oh. Like, I love them. Wow. I can eat a whole bag. But now I've sworn off of them. I'm no longer allowed to have them because I feel like they, like, burned my insides sometimes. When I eat them, I feel like it,
you
like,
could feel
hurt.
Your life.
It, like,
you could
hurts
feel your life
my
shortening.
Stomach. I'm, like, having a whole bag. My stomach is, like, aching. And then I'm, like, talking to my friends. And they're like, well, why did you keep eating them if it's, like, making your stomach hurt? And, like, because they're good.
Yes.
So I've banned myself from eating them because... I'll like eat till I have like my stomach a stomach ache. So anyway,
it is interesting. Like, again, actually, that's the thing. Like, sort of like UK versus like American, because there is definitely more of like a heat and a spice thing here. Like, because I think when I had like the Flaming Hot Cheetos, they are like, I would call them really hot. Like, they actually are like,
yeah,
kind of what I would describe as like too hot. Like, I can eat them and I can like. I can just about tolerate them, but I would call them too hot. It's kind of one of those things where it's like, I wouldn't want to have, I kind of almost probably couldn't have them without, say, just having like a glass of water or something like that. I don't need like milk and ice cream and whatever, but I'd want to have like a glass of water or something like that.
No, I mean, I think it's one of those things where when you've had a lot, it just like burns like a top layer of your taste buds away, and then you're just like,
whereas like the UK has these crisps called Monster Munch, and they have like a hot version, and like they're a little bit hot, but they're definitely not hot like some of the hot like potato chips that I've like had out here, kind of thing. But then it's interesting because stuff that's described as sour out here is like, or some of the stuff that's like described as sour is like not sour, or things that I look at where I think, oh, that'll be sour, and then they're like not sour. Whereas like the UK kind of likes sour candy and stuff like that, and there'll be things where like, you know, if you get something where it's like fruity and it's got like a load of sugar on the outside, like in the UK it's probably sour, whereas here they're like just really sweet.
I feel like we need to do like a taste test. see like what level of sour and what level of heat. we'll do a video about it sometime.
Sometime
in the future. We'll plan it out.
We'll do that and like watch Emperor's New Groove and all these
things.
And
of course, we have to watch Emperor's New Groove. So Beau and I both love Emperor's New Groove, and so sometimes we'll send each other the like Emperor's New Groove like memes and stuff.
We've probably like sent each other like 20% of the script in memes.
In gifs and memes.
In
and
memes,
stuff.
Gifs and memes and
wrong
stuff.
Wrong level.
Like. Yeah.
Oh yeah, no, we both love Emperor's New Groove. Such a good movie.
For me so far, like this stream isn't just good, I would perhaps describe it as brilliant, brilliant, brilliant.
Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. Oh man, so good, so good. Okay, well, I guess we'll just like talk to this dude.
I wonder if I took things a little too far.
I have another joke in a second.
I'm scared out of my mind.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. let me finish. Okay, so who are you?
Huh?
Wait, hey, is this person pretending to be... Aw, man. Mind.
I assume you overheard me anyway. I work here pretending to be a ghost, but now's my break time, so I took off my costume. I get all hot and stuffy wearing that thing.
So there are no real ghosts here?
Of course. How could there be real ghosts here? No one wants to see a real ghost, neither us nor the participants. You just come here for the atmosphere, or should I say, the chance. Everyone wants the chance to feel the thrill of excitement. When people find themselves in a scary situation, they'll say things that they'd never dare to otherwise. That's what the test of courage is all about.
Chongyun will be very disappointed.
Okay. I should get back to work now. Hope you and whoever you're here with have a fun time.
Okay, wait, tell me your joke.
Oh, yeah, so basically, there's so much, like, preface to this. Just like, what to like, say one line from Emperor's New Groove, and I have to, like, set out. But basically, this week, I sort of, in, like, the past week or so, my brother was, like, visiting my family, and I've had this, like, long-term plan to maybe have some of my old Pokemon games and stuff sent out to me, stuff that I wasn't able to bring with me when I moved here, because you're only allowed, like, a 50-pound suitcase or whatever like that, you know. So you have to kind of, you know, when you're moving your whole life somewhere else, you have to pick your stuff wisely.
Which is so crazy.
And be very minimalistic in your choices. So I wasn't able to bring, like, all my games and stuff. And I was like, but I want some of my Pokemon things. And I'm in a position where I think I can, like, do that and, like, have some of them again now. And, so basically I got my brother to, like, sort out some of my stuff. I kind of had my stuff fairly neatly organized, so he was able to just kind of find it, and it was kind of all together, and he sort of, you know, kind of sorted it out, and then my parents mailed it out to me. But again, I kind of had it all organized and neatly,
yeah,
you know, arranged and stuff like that. So in some ways, it was like... So I took this stuff and I put it in a box, and I put that box inside a bigger box, and then I mailed that box to myself, and then when it arrived, I squished it with a hammer!
With a hammer!
It's brilliant, brilliant, brilliant! It literally precedes that line, doesn't it? But anyway, yeah, so I did not squish Pokemon stuff with a hammer, don't worry. And just for anyone who saw my tweet...
For the memes.
Without going into a huge thing, I did a tweet where I was kind of like, oh, I sent all this stuff out to myself, and I had this grand plan, and now I may not be able to do the grand plan because of weird, like, my console is English, but I live in America reasons. But basically, I've got it...
Oh, because it needs, like, a...
Huh? There's weird stuff. I won't get into it, but because it's too much to get into.
Oh, that's
but
right.
We want to see how the test of courage goes. But basically, I've got it sorted now. So for anyone who saw that tweet, and I am going to do another tweet, like, saying that, like, don't worry, everything's fine now. But there's just, like, a particular screenshot I want to get of, like, everything being fine now. That I will then post. I'll post the tweet. So everything's fine now, but I'm just in the middle of doing this stuff that I want to do now that I actually can do it. But basically, yeah, I had this stuff I wanted to do, and then there was this weird kind of barrier. Again, there's all kinds of weird little barriers that you get from little things where it's like, you know, like, say a random example was, like, I had to close down my, like, UK PayPal account and then open a new one with, like, the exact same email address, but, like, open an American PayPal account.
That's so weird, because, like, you know, so PayPal does anything, so, like, can convert to any...
Yeah, but because it was, like, a UK account, I couldn't put, like, an American debit card on it, because the American debit card had, like, an American address attached to it, and it needed to have, like, a UK... So the card needed to have an address to it that was matching the country of the PayPal account. So, again, that's, like, a stupid little thing that you don't really even... There's so many stupid little things like that that you don't even... Like, I was on top of so many of these little things. I was, like, prepared for them. But then, like, a bazillion more, like, come out of the woodwork to surprise you, and you're like, oh, what, this, like, oh man, I didn't think this, you know,
like, so another thing,
you know, they're just all these random things that pop up. And even, like, say, you know, after you've been here for a while, like, you'd think, like, oh, this is, like, in, like, the first, like, few months, right? And it's like, no, even, like, after a year or so, or, like, 2 years, like, something will happen, and you'll be like, oh, like, I still got, you know, whatever, like, ties to your old life or whatever. But anyway, sorry, test of courage. Do the test of courage.
Yeah, that's moving is hard in general, but also moving.
Yeah, yeah. All around, it's just.
But you're doing great. And you're here. And we're so excited that you're here.
I love being here. It's absolutely brilliant.
We love that you're here.
I love it to bits.
Okay, so I guess we're going to go talk to Chongyun again.
Oh, yeah, we got a disappointment. I just remembered where we were.
Oh, no.
See an evil spirit?
Got to break his heart.
I know. No, I only saw an event staff member pretending to be a ghost.
So that's what's going on here? No evil spirits? No danger? It's all just a setup?
I'm gonna say, okay, well, there's, I'm sorry, but that seems to be the truth. That's all there is to the test of courage, and it's just for entertainment. You took it way too seriously. I feel like we should say sorry.
Yes. Sorry is always good.
I'm sorry, but that seems to be the truth.
I
see. Heartbreak!
So I was wrong again. In that case, I suppose there's no reason for us to linger.
But see, none of those two answers are really, like, I mean, the first one's obviously, like, a way more gentle and nice thing, but still, like, either way, it's sad for him.
I know. Okay, so there's one where I'm like, let's go look at the strange mist, and then one that's, right, let's head back. I feel like we should go look at the strange mist.
Yeah, like, there was mist. Like, there was genuinely something there. Like, we didn't just run into this guy pretending or anything. Like, we genuinely saw
something.
There some
is
weird,
something!
Weird stuff. Like, yeah.
There's something happening! I'm gonna say, remember that strange mist we found earlier? I would like to investigate that further.
Yes, that was
proof.
Like,
I remember us talking about
presence.
Cheetos, but oh yeah, the mist.
We can't be sure if the spirit's still here. Actually, I would also like to investigate that further.
We've already come all this way. Let's have a look.
You're right. I'll focus my mind and spirit.
Yay! Perhaps focus your mind and spirit!
Split up. Evil spirits will keep their distance if they sense the power of my pure yang spirit.
Okay.
So you'll be more likely to find one if you're on your own.
I'm gonna ask if I should wait for you instead of be like, I might defeat the spirit by the time you arrive. I'm gonna ask, like, should I wait for you? Right?
Yeah, no, that's
I think
good.
That's right. Okay, I'm gonna do, and then I'll wait for you to come and defeat it?
Yes, that would be best. Just keep it distracted till I arrive. I'll take this side, you take the other side. Let's move.
Yay! Okay.
So, I think both of those actually work out, like, fine. But,
oh,
but that
like,
one's,
goes
but
to the same.
But that one, yeah, but that one's, like, definitely the better option of the two, in my head.
Oh, man, there's a ghost! Whoa! Well,
is this where I get to hear one of the famous Sarah? Oh no!
Oh no! Well, it's not attacking me yet.
Sorry, I don't really get to watch my friend's streams much and stuff like that, but I swear every time I like watch like 10 minutes of Sarah's, I will always hear and oh no!
Oh no! Or screaming. I feel like it's one of the two.
I love it. It's great.
Just me. Oh, no. Okay, so we found a spirit. She's crying.
Can you help me?
Help you?
That exorcist with the blue hair is so scary. Can you lead him away from here? He makes me feel so frightened.
Are you being affected by his yang energy?
I wouldn't dare get anywhere near him. His energy, it's so horrible. It'll make me disappear. I don't want to disappear. Please, help me.
He'll have to be the one that decides what to do.
Well, I have an idea. I saw the exorcist with blue hair arguing with someone over there a few minutes ago. I'll scare those troublemakers away, but you have to ask the exorcist to let me go, okay?
Are you telling the truth?
Of course. Genshin never lies. So, what do you say?
He'll be the one that decides, but I'll try to explain the situation as best I can.
Okay. So, I'll take that as a yes? I hope the exorcist with blue hair is a good person. So, I'll help him, and you'll go talk to him. Hopefully then he'll leave me alone. Sound good?
Okay, so now we gotta go rescue you. Chongyun. AKA you. Why are you arguing with people? Okay, let's go see. What's happening here?
Hey, you've been turning the whole place upside down looking for evil spirits.
These are like the event planners.
Yeah, why would an exorcist show up at the test of courage and tell everyone that there are no ghosts here?
Oh my gosh, Chongyun's just going around being like, guys, there aren't any ghosts here.
Honestly, I find this whole thing quite confusing. If there really are ghosts here, then you're using them to make Mora regardless of the participant's safety. You tell me, is that ethical business practice?
Oh.
And if there are no ghosts here,
Chongyun's
so-called test of courage is nothing but a big scam. Not only are you avoiding my questions, but now you accuse me of causing trouble?
I've already told you. This is what kind of event the test of courage is. It's not our problem that you're taking it so seriously. And now that you're disturbing our participants, we'll have to ask you to leave.
If anything about this made any sense at all, I would leave of my own volition. But if I leave now, I'm leaving evil spirits to their own devices.
I wonder what I should say in this situation.
No!
Run for your life!
Run for your life!
What's going on?
Everyone's starting to panic. Is there really a ghost?
Yeah, there's really a ghost.
Don't be silly. But if everyone starts running, someone could get hurt. Everyone, just calm down. No need to panic. Please move in an orderly fashion.
I see. So there's no evil spirits here. Just a wandering ghost. And she scared everyone away because I was in trouble?
She only scared them. She didn't hurt anyone.
If things are as you say, then she doesn't seem like a malignant spirit.
Okay, our choices are, she's a ghost, but she's also just a kid, or I'll let you be the judge.
I don't mind either of those. I think the second one is the, like, letting you be the judge is, like, a little bit better. I don't think any of them are, like, inherently bad, but I think that one's the better one.
Okay, we'll do that one. I'm gonna say, I'll let you be the judge.
All right. As long as she promises not to harm anyone, then I'll pretend that I never knew about her. However, if she ever does harm anyone, it'll be my job as an exorcist to come and purge her. To mend my mistake.
Okay, we've got, I don't think that day will ever come, or I'll be equally responsible too. I think the first one, right?
Yeah, we'll go with that. I had no particular preference.
I don't think that day will ever come.
I hope so. We should go now. It doesn't seem we're particularly welcome here anyway. What's wrong?
I was under the impression that you wouldn't be willing to let her go.
I have faith in my judgment of good and evil. But if I begin to neglect my perception of good and evil, it may lead to something I'd regret for the rest of my days.
Okay, I'm gonna choose the nice option. this sounds just like something you would say.
Wait, you mean...
Oh!
You didn't think I could be fair and reasonable? Really? Do I look so obstinate?
I thought that was the nice answer. The other one was like, I didn't know you had a gentle side. That felt rude.
Yeah, no, but that's like,
but
that's
now
what
he's
I mean.
Offended.
Well, like, both.
He's offended no matter what.
Yeah, no, I know. It's, yeah.
Okay, so then the answers are, it doesn't matter, or I know you better now. I think we'll do the second one, right? Because it's our hangout. We're becoming friends.
Yeah.
Or no. We'll do that one. Yeah?
Yeah. So sorry. Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna say, I know you better now.
Yeah, you're right. All right. We should leave now.
Okay, we've got, wait a moment. I don't know how to say this ghost's name. Chen-Chen?
Maybe? Oh, Chen-Chen, yeah.
Chen-Chen? Wait a moment, or let's say goodbye to Chen-Chen. Should we say goodbye?
Yeah, we'll say goodbye.
Let's say goodbye to Chen-Chen.
Okay.
Chongyun was like, let me think about it. Yay! We did it!
Yay!
We finished. That's the first ending of this thing. We did it! So I guess the question is, do we want to do other endings? Or... Oh, I got a potato. Or... Are you satisfied with the amount we've done?
I'm happy to do more. It would be cool. It would be cool if we could kind of go, because basically there's like the test of courage and then there's like another thing.
Okay.
There are like three endings revolving around the test of courage. The really funny thing is one of the answers I gave, I was like, this definitely won't lead us to the test of courage. And then you started reading test of courage stuff and I was like,
I already did that.
I think the test of courage is the one where like there are just more options that kind of lead you towards it, which is why it kind of ends up being the one that like people end up doing.
Okay, so I guess I'll go back to the wharf, and then we'll see if we can get ourselves on.
Yeah,
the
I think
other if, one.
If you remember the drunkards, I think it may be that point, because the three options there was like there's test of courage, the like shadow, and drunkards. And I think maybe if you pick the drunkards, maybe that is the quote-unquote nexus point, but we'll see.
Okay, we're just gonna like, if we're just doing, okay, let's see what happens.
But yeah, if there's a lot of the same dialogue, we can talk
we'll just skip through it, yeah.
Check for super chats or whatever, yeah. Like, yeah.
Have you perchance seen
okay,
any
so we did this, we did this, sorry, Chongyun, we're just skipping through. Okay, so is it
and protect the citizens here from their
vigilant
evil
yaksha? Or, like, is it the one that's like, so Chongyun says, it's my duty to exercise or destroy them and protect the citizens from their evil doings. And then... is it, I get it, that's what the vigilant yaksha fights against, right? And then the other one is, that sounds similar to the work of adventurers.
I don't know if either of those have an impact, a Genshin impact, if you will. Sorry. I don't know if either of those have a, again, because I can't quite remember, because one of the things as well when you're like recording, I know like I've sat through people doing this, so I kind of should know, but that was a long time ago. And when you're recording it, I remember like the stories as I'm recording them, but I didn't necessarily get a sense of like what ones would lead to what as a player.
I'm not expecting you to know that. We're just going to try it and see.
I think, I'm not sure if this one
matters.
Really has, yeah. So, but the yaksha one is kind of the nicer of the two.
Okay, we'll do that.
So I'd go with that.
I'm going to say...
And if it leads to the test of courage, I'm so sorry.
We'll just come back. I'll say, I get it. That's what the vigilant yaksha fights against, right?
How did you come to know of the vigilant yaksha? I have great respect for the yakshas. For generations, yakshas and exorcists have been protecting Liyue together. One in plain sight, and the other in secret. Sorry, I digress. Judging from your response, it seems you aren't well-versed in the realm of evil spirits. But that's understandable. If I may ask, have you happened to come across anything strange recently? Sometimes even the most trivial matters prove helpful in my hunt for evil spirits.
I'm a little concerned that we're going down the same path, but we'll see.
Well, fair enough.
I thought it was like the drunkards.
Well,
because
like, because now I'm back. Like, now I'm doing like more. It's like all the choices have check marks.
Oh no!
I think. Let's like skip through it and just see.
So can I just point out one thing? I don't mean this in like a defensive way or anything like that. But again, if you sort of said, oh, one of these two questions is kind of the divergent point between the test of courage and something else. One where the test of courage, like, oh, what should we, which of these is like interesting?
Right.
Test of courage, drunkards, or a shadow, or yaksha, blah blah blah, an adventurer.
Oh no, wait, I'm wrong, because we just got to this part and drunkards is the option. You were right.
Okay.
You were right.
We'll pick the drunkards.
Whoop, whoop. Okay, so I'm gonna say, sometimes drunkards pass by people's windows at night. That's nothing unusual.
And if it's the test of courage that takes us to the non-test of courage thing, then just what the heck?
Then we don't even know anymore.
Do you think I'm not deciphering these clues correctly?
They all sound pretty far-fetched. Perhaps I should just tell him that. I'm picking the one I haven't chosen yet.
Yeah, I was gonna say, just be mean to him for a sec.
Sorry. Please give me a moment to calm myself.
I'm sorry, I didn't realize it would be so devastating to you. So rude!
I mean, we actually did, but we'd already picked the other one, but we can't tell him that.
I know. Oh, is it health related?
No, not at all. I guess you could say that I just tend to be unstable. You know, emotionally. It causes me to become very uncomfortable at times. This tendency of getting stirred up easily is what people call a pure yang spirit.
Stirred up easily? I couldn't tell that from your appearance.
Yes, well, such a constitution is very rare. But it's a potent weapon for an exorcist. My constitution alone is capable of scaring off evil spirits. But I must constantly focus on my emotions. Otherwise, I may easily do something out of control. Anyway, I carefully selected these clues from an ocean of information. I can't believe they're all completely irrelevant. Oh no. I'm still feeling quite uncomfortable. There's heat growing in my chest. I
Oh no, Chongyun!
I can't breathe.
Okay, it says, should I try rubbing your vision on your forehead? Shall I take you to Boo Boo Pharmacy and how about some water? I feel like
to the pharmacy one.
Okay, yeah. Because why would rubbing someone's vision on their forehead make any difference? Okay. Okay, I'm gonna say, shall I take you to Boo Boo Pharmacy?
No, I'll be all right.
Can I just say, when you said that, Boo Boo Pharmacy, I thought, for a split second there, I thought you were saying or going to say Moo Moo Farm, the Mario Kart, the Mario Kart 64 track. Which, again, just like classic Nintendo people. Well, no, they put it in other games as well.
Oh my gosh. That's so funny. Okay, wait, so Chongyun feels better now. Do we say that's an unexpected solution or it looked tasty?
How about it looked tasty?
Will be nice. It looked tasty.
Actually, they're quite tasteless.
Oh.
Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to stomach them.
Chongyun's like, they are flavored water. Concern.
Yeah.
I'm fine now. But what should I do next if all these clues are irrelevant?
Actually, it seems someone's been watching us this whole time.
Yes, I've noticed him too.
Okay, good. We are triggering the other part.
That we both noticed it. I'm sure he's watching us. But it doesn't seem he has any intentions other than looking at us. Perhaps there's something he wishes to tell us.
Okay, let's go ask him. Let's go and ask him.
Right. He might need our help.
Go talk to this child. Speaking of Mario Kart.
Yeah, go for it.
I did a Mario Kart stream, I think with my brother and some other people. And I was like, why does this squid keep pooping on me? And they were like, that's a ghost. Or it's like that's
no,
a
no, they're But there
no,
is a
I, I kept saying, no, I kept saying, why does this ghost
oh,
keep
ghost.
Pooping on me?
Oh, okay.
And everyone was like, no, that's a squid, and it's inking on you. And I'm like, it obviously looks like a ghost, and it's very clearly pooping on me. Anyway, so now in my server, if you're a part of my server, you can see there are stickers, and my people in my server made all the characters as ghost squids. We call them ghost squids now because My compromise was that we could call it a ghost squid. So now we have, people have like created the like bloopers, but like put like the characters like hair and like.
I was gonna say that's funny because basically you made a blooper about bloopers.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Can I just say a funny, this is where I'm such a Nintendo dork. I'm even wearing a Super Nintendo t-shirt right now.
Hey!
But it's got like the control of these sort of Japanese and European style control. See, tangent to my tangent. The shirt
Fair.
I'm wearing, so it's got like a sort of European / Japanese style Super Nintendo controller. So like in the UK, if I wore this shirt, it would just be like, oh, that's a Super Nintendo controller. But over here, it's like a super geeky t-shirt because it like looks different than what everyone else here had as a controller for their Super Nintendos. So they're like, oh, that's like a Japanese one. That, you know, they sort of think like, oh, that's like a Japanese one. Like, oh, you've got like the Japanese version.
Oh, like people thought you're being
thing.
Like. It,
whereas I'm like, no, I'm just English. Like, it's like that's and we had the same one. Like, it, you know, so just this for me is a Super Nintendo controller. You know. The American one, sort of, is the one that, like, looks
like,
weird to
that's
me.
That's the weird one. But, you know, we definitely need to, like, have a Chongyun ghost squid made for my server. So anyone who's here in my server who wants to edit one, so I can send it to Beau.
And then so that was my tangent to the tangent. And then the original tangent, because I do remember, I was just going to say, the blooper had a really cool, like, origin in Mario Kart games, because... It first appeared in the Nintendo DS Mario Kart, and the Nintendo DS was where it had the two screens. So you had just like the main screen at the top, which you generally had your gameplay on, and then your like the touch screen on the bottom. And on the and the Mario Kart game on that one, it was like you played on the top, and then you had like a map of the track on the bottom, and you could see where everyone was, and if they were like throwing an item at you, you could see like the shell on that map like heading towards you. So it was really cool. So you could be like, ah, someone's like throwing a red shell at me. Ah, I gotta do something, you know, like, before it gets
oh,
to
no!
Kind of, oh no, yeah, exactly. And so the really cool thing about the blooper was obviously it kind of still does this, but it doesn't do it as severely as it did in like the DS game and the 3DS game. But like the blooper kind of like obscures your vision. But in the DS game, it like really, really like covered ink on like most of the screen. Like you could barely see anything because what you would then do is you had to drive using the map on the bottom screen as your guide. Like you had to kind of look at the bottom screen to kind of like follow the map. And that was your like main way of driving. Like now it's just like a minor inconvenience. Sometimes you like can't quite see something if like the particular like splot of ink is like a bit inconvenient or convenient, or sort of like too convenient. But back in those days, it like kind of pretty much covered the whole screen, and then you'd use the second screen as like your navigation until it went away, which is like a really cool use of like the dual screen technology. Like the DS had a lot of cool ways that it utilized like having two screens, and the blooper was like a really cool way they did it in Mario Kart. So anyway, there's your geeky Nintendo fact of the day.
I love it. My brother just bought a DS, like,
oh nice.
He had always had one, and then like when we were younger, but then obviously like he didn't have one anymore, and then he was like, I'm feeling nostalgic, so he like just bought one like on Facebook Marketplace, like he just like bought a used one. So he's been playing some. I'll have to tell him I know this tidbit now. He'll be so impressed. Okay, so I guess we'll talk to this child that's been staring at us.
Oh yeah. Who's just been staring all this time.
Okay. Oh, autoplay.
Sorry, I'll leave now.
No, please, relax. There's no need to worry. We're not here for trouble. We couldn't help but notice you standing here for a while and thought that you might have something on your mind.
No, there's nothing on my mind. I just thought the thing you were eating looked tasty. My sister just loves food. She's always super happy whenever we get some tasty snacks. I'm her big brother, and I should take care of her, but Mom says we're too poor, and she never lets me buy any snacks.
Oh, you mean one of my popsicles? I'm afraid you wouldn't find them very tasty, though.
Oh, it doesn't matter. My sister's never had anything like that before. I know she'd be happy to try one. Come to think of it, I've never had one either.
I see. That might be difficult.
Also, Karina Becker is in the chat. Everybody say hi to Karina. Hi, Cor. Welcome. I'm so glad you're here. Okay. Everyone say hi to Karina in chat. Say hello. Yes. Karina said, Paimon has graced this live stream. Yes, Paimon has. Karina, I was just talking earlier about that everyone should go back to watch the Among Us streams because of how hilarious you were. You were like, you were coming so hard for people. You were like, what is it? Oh, Beau, what's the other? No bars, no. Oh, no.
No ifs, no buts, no coconuts?
No holds barred. No,
oh, no holds barred. Oh,
no,
right.
No bars hold.
No holds barred.
Yeah. No holds barred. That sounds really wrong.
I know. Okay. I think I do have that right, or I'm very close.
It sounds
right.
Completely wrong, no, when I say it, but I feel like it's right. Karina, we love you too. We love you too.
We love you, Cor.
Lots of hearts. Okay, so I'm gonna say, what's wrong?
Well, Chongyun's gonna. I only have two popsicles left.
Chongyun's like, I only have two popsicles, and I need them.
And I might need them if we encounter an evil spirit. Without them, I might not be able to control my constitution.
Should I say that we should give him one or both? Just one, right?
So again, you know, like we had the drink conundrum earlier, where it was kind of like, was kind of like, well, let's do the option where like Chongyun would still kind of be okay. Sort of thing.
Okay, we'll choose that one.
I think like the one each thing is a pretty good, yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna say, what if you just give him one of the popsicles?
Just give him one?
If this leads us back to the test of courage.
I know, if this leads us back to the test of courage, I don't know what I'll do.
Because I feel like there is one path where you start to, now that I think about it, we start to do this and then you go back to the test of courage. And now I'm like, oh my gosh,
better not.
Just, because I want to do this, because this other path is like really funny and there's like lots of fun stuff. Like the test of courage stuff is really funny, don't get me wrong, but it's just, but I want to do a stream, or another stream.
We want to do this one!
Yeah, this one.
Anyway, back to our hunt for evil spirits. Earlier it seemed like you could easily discern which clues were most credible. You must truly be a knowledgeable and seasoned adventurer.
I was just using good old common sense.
I still have numerous clues from my friend, which I haven't sorted through yet. With my limited experience, it's hard to tell whether they're reliable leads. If you'd be willing, could you please come and take a look with me?
Sure thing.
All right. Let's go to Wanwen Bookhouse. Please, follow me.
Okay, we're going to the bookhouse. Is this leading us?
I think this is okay. I think this is good. I hope.
Somehow we're gonna get. I just feel like it's gonna take us somehow to the test of courage.
I know. Fingers crossed in the chat, everyone. Spam the fingers crossed in the chat. Like, spam that emoji or just, like, use the phrase fingers crossed. Like, spam the chat.
Okay, here we go.
I have actually literally crossed my fingers. You don't have to. You're playing a game. That would probably.
Okay, this is. I don't need to run all the way. I can just teleport here. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay, here we go.
Sorry, I'm still thinking about the phrase no holds barred.
I feel like I don't understand.
I'm gonna Google it.
I need you to look it up and tell me the etymology?
I'm gonna Google it.
Is that the phrase that means like the origin of a word?
Yes, I think you're right.
No. Yes! Can't believe it.
It just came up with Chris Pratt. No holds barred.
Everything is Chris Pratt.
No holds barred in wrestling with no restrictions on the kinds of holds that are used. And then used to convey. So that's the origin, and then used to convey that no rules or restrictions apply in a conflict or dispute. So there you go. No holds barred. That's the way to think of it. So it's like no hold, like no, you can't.
No chokeholds are not allowed.
There are no holds that are not allowed. Yeah, exactly. That's kind of. I think I kind of knew that, which is why I was like, I think this. It's also a movie from 1989 with Hulk Hogan in it.
Huh?
What? Yeah, no, it's got a 4.4 out of 10
it's
on IMDb.
It's called No Holds Barred?
Yes.
Okay, every time I say that in my mind, different words are coming up. Like barred this time came up as B-A-R-D, like in my head when I was thinking.
Oh, like venting.
this is like spinning off into something else in my head. Okay, so
if we check the
we're
books
here at
Wanwen Bookhouse.
According
to the respective clues on the note, we'll be able to find the complete details of each clue. Since you're here to help, I'll just read the clues to you, and you can help me judge if they're credible or not based on your experience.
Leave it to me.
All right. Here are the first clues.
Okay, so we're getting the clues.
At the foot of Mount Qingsa is a violet grass that has turned into a gigantic, man-eating monster.
Huh?
Also, there's a ghostly shadow skulking about Feiyun Slope at night. It's suspected to be a vengeful spirit. And finally, lurking in Liyue Harbor is a massive demon that was transformed from a popsicle. Huh. I've never encountered any such things before. Anyway, could you pick the one that seems most plausible and likely to be the work of evil spirits?
Okay, so are we going to Liyue Harbor to a demon that was transformed from a popsicle? Are we going to the foot of Mount Qixing with a violet grass that has turned into a gigantic man-eating monster? Or are we going to, there's a ghostly shadow skulking about Feiyun Slope at night. It's suspected to be a vengeful spirit. Isn't the ghostly shadow going to be where we just came from?
I would think that. So hang on, what were the options? Sorry, I was looking up another thing. Like, I sort of just started, like, sorry, I just started like Googling another thing because I'm like, after this, I have to send you something. But so I'm kind of, I
no,
kind
it's
of, like,
not Qixing, it's Mount Qingsa. Oh my gosh. Anyway, there's Liyue Harbor, demon from a popsicle, there's violet grass at the foot of the mountain that has turned into a giant man-eating monster, and then ghostly shadow skulking about. It's suspected to be a vengeful spirit. I feel like
so
ghostly.
So do you want to do like the second? What the second one? Sorry, they all had very long titles.
Okay, yeah, popsicle demon, man-eating monster grass, or vengeful spirit. And I feel like vengeful spirit is where we just came from.
Yeah, right? so we'll ignore that one. Yeah.
So we'll go to the man-eating grass?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, let's do... At the foot of Mount Qingsa is a violet grass that has turned into a gigantic man-eating monster. Oh!
This one seems unlikely. If such a thing did exist, there would be many witnesses in Qingsa Village. But nobody has yet to
Chongyun
see it.
Was like, no, that's not a likely one.
How about these clues?
Oh, so I have a funny thing to point out in a second. Again, because I'm not watching it, I sort of just realized, like, kind of what's happening here and stuff.
Or, in Zhuiyun Karst, there's a piece of a 1,000-year-old amber that has gained consciousness and now roams about causing trouble. And lastly, it's said that people often see.
So now he's giving me three more options to choose from.
Okay, so I'm gonna just say my thing. Like, Chris and I said this and another thing, and it's just really funny. As we were, like, doing this hangout, like, particularly as we were, like, recording it, I was like, oh my gosh, there are, like, all these paths, and you're probably gonna have all these endings like that, because there are all these different options. And in my head, I'm thinking, oh, you go off and, like, go to the base of this mountain and investigate this thing, and you go chase after that thing. And it's like... But basically what kind of happens is, for most of these options, you say them and Chongyun's like, nah, that doesn't make sense. And then he'll just like tell you a bunch more stuff, and then it's like, nah, not that one. And it's kind of almost like that point in the Simpsons movie where it's like, pick a number, it's like two, it's like, not that one. It's like five, no, like, and again, and it's like number three, and it's like, thank you. And it's kind of like that, where it's kind of like, You'd think based on all these things he's saying, there are all these things you can or will go do, but actually it basically just amounts to like the test of courage and this other thing that hopefully, fingers crossed, spam the chat people, fingers crossed, we will get to.
Okay, well, so now, okay, but I lost a heart, so now, because I chose the wrong one. Okay, so there's a demon who loves eating chilies at this restaurant. There's a demon that has been raiding commercial fishing boats and building a luxurious palace. There's a piece of 1,000-year-old amber that has gained consciousness and now roams about causing trouble.
So I know this is like probably the most boring of those three answers, but I would go with the chilies and the restaurant.
Okay. It's said that people often see a demon who loves eating chilies in Wanmin restaurant. No, that's wrong!
What?
Not some demon. Okay.
So did you, like, lose a heart there?
I did!
A strange man wearing a mask.
So basically, I've just the restaurant is a part of what I what like the branch we're trying to do here. So I was like, let's pick the restaurant because hopefully that means we go to the restaurant. That's what it, that was the logic. Like again, I did, like I sort of said, I know it wasn't like I kind of knew it wasn't like the most exciting answer or necessarily the best one, but I was hoping and thinking that that would lead us to where I want us to go. And if we end up at the test of courage.
Okay, well, like, here's the
test
problem.
Test of courage is fun, but
I feel like we're a test of courage, possibly, because one says there's a vigilant demon adept at concealing itself in mist. Recently, people have found traces of it in Mingyang Village, Guili Plains, and Yaoguang Shoal. And isn't that test of courage?
I don't know anymore, Sarah.
I don't know! And then the other one is, a strange man wearing a mask and wielding a pole was once seen in the distance around Guili Plains. There's something eerie about his presence. And then the last one I saw an exorcist with blue hair who's actually a transformed demon, which would be Chongyun.
I mean, that we could go for that one for the memes because it's hilarious. We've already lost two hearts, Sarah.
So at this point, we should just try to lose them all?
Gotta lose them all.
Should I choose that last one?
Yeah, do it. It's fine.
Oh, darn it. Okay. How about I saw an exorcist with blue hair who's actually a transformed demon? Oh! It just ended! Hangout event ended! Seeing that the traveler is unable to make anything more out of the clues, Chongyun bids farewell and leaves in disappointment.
Wait, that was like all the hearts? Oh, I didn't know you only had one. I thought you had like two left. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, I thought you had more than one. I thought you had more than one hearts left.
Oh, wait. Oh, no, I did this one. What? Okay. Oh, no. Okay, wait. Oh, wait, huh?
Sorry, I love that. I have no idea what's going on now.
Oh, okay, so that's Test of Courage. Okay, a curious... Okay. Oh, on the evil spirit's trail? There's like two endings from this child. One. And the one we went on is on the spirit's trails. Okay, all right, let's try again.
This is a note that I received from a friend.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Also, and finally.
Okay.
Anyway.
Because I thought you had like four hearts, and there were like two times where I knew you'd like lost hearts, so I was thinking you had like two left. I wouldn't have probably said that.
No, don't be sorry. I have no idea what's going on.
That seemed very ruthless. Like, we didn't really pick anything that was, like, that bad. Like, we didn't really pick anything. Again, given how rude and sassy some of those answers are.
I know. Like, okay,
and
okay.
And it's just being like, let's go to a restaurant. Like,
here's the thing. We're supposed to pick the one that seems the most plausible, but I'm pretty sure the one at Feiyun Slope is the test of courage. So, the other one is that there's a massive demon that transformed into a popsicle. So that seems less likely, but I think that I'm gonna choose that one.
If we didn't pick it, go for it. Okay. Like, yeah. Again, that's funny as well. That and the Exorcist one are like the funniest of these like non-options that you kind of have.
Okay. Lurking in Liyue Harbor is a massive demon that was transformed from a popsicle.
Popsicle.
That's a fail too. Oh no.
I always keep a close eye on my
what is going on?
Deep in the sea of clouds, a marauding demon.
Okay.
I know he has like a bit of an adverse reaction to that, but still, like.
Okay, so there's deep in the sea of clouds, a marauding demon has been raiding commercial fishing boats and building a luxurious palace. And in Jeyun Karas, there's a piece of 1,000-year-old amber that has gained consciousness and now roams around causing trouble.
Do you want to do the first one of those two things you?
Okay.
Dead, which was... I can't remember.
Yeah. Deep in the sea of clouds, a marauding demon has been raiding commercial fishing boats and building a luxurious palace.
This one does
We did
possible.
It!
Yay! Thank goodness.
Plus, Plus, we don't have any.
But again, like, what would have been fundamentally wrong with either of those? And maybe they are both good. I don't know, but I can't remember. But again, it's been like probably like half a year or something like that since I last did one of these. But still, like,
Or someone saw an exorcist with blue hair who was actually a transformed demon. Wait, what? And finally, there is a vigilant demon adept at concealing itself in mist.
Okay. Okay, there is a vigilant demon adept at concealing itself in the mist. Recently, people have found traces of it in Mingyang Village, Guili Plains, and Yaoguang Shoal. Or, a strange man wearing a mask and wielding a pole was once seen in the distance around Guili Plains. There's something very eerie about his presence.
Do you want to go with... Okay, do you want to go with that one? Because it's the least test of courage-y of the two. Even though it's like about like a person, so he'll probably just be like, that's not a spirit or whatever. Like,
we're gonna try
that one. We're gonna try it.
A strange man wearing a mask and wielding a pole was once seen in the distance around Guili Plains. There's something eerie about his presence. Oh no!
I mean, we knew it. Like, it's not really that. It's not a surprise at this point. But it's just. I mean, this stream could just be called Beau and Sarah desperately try not to do the trial more than once, you know?
I know. But okay, I'm going to say, out of curiosity.
Because every other time I've done it, we've, like, picked answers where it, like, just still somehow winds up back there. Even ones I'm kind of like, I don't think this will lead us back to the test of courage.
But we didn't fail. So it let us keep going because we got one right. So I'm going to say, out of curiosity, who gave you these clues?
Oh, many of these are from my friend,
Xingqiu. Oh, this is funny.
He's well-read and very knowledgeable. Not to mention, he's always willing to extend a helping hand. He always provides me with lots of reliable information. If it weren't for my pure Yang spirit, I would have already vanquished numerous demons because of him. I'm sure of it. I should find a chance to thank him personally.
Okay, so there's such enviable friendship, and the other is, maybe you should change your source of information. Let's do the first one.
Yeah.
Even though it's also an insult.
It's about Xingqiu, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's
I'm gonna say, such enviable friendship.
Yes. He always goes out of his way.
Chongyun had like a heart by his head.
He never seems to mind, and helps me all the same. Also, he often has something interesting to say. I'm quite glad that I get along with him. Sorry, I digress. I've found another snippet of information here. There aren't many details, but it clearly mentions Wu Wang Hill. If we include the test of courage rumor from before,
there are already
two clues pointing there.
What happened? What I missed?
I think it's this test of courage!
Let's go and have a look. We might just find something useful.
What?
What? I hope we can find something there.
All right. Let's head out and see what we can find.
Because it wants us to go to Wuwon Hill.
I think there is one where you do go to Wuwon Hill a little bit, but then you don't. Like, I think you do a little bit of stuff.
Okay.
I think this is right, because I think there is one where you do a bit of stuff in Wuwon Hill, and then afterwards they sort of be like, wow, now that we've done that, and then it kind of leads into the thing that I'm hoping.
Okay, I'm going.
We won't be discouraged.
It might actually take us where we want to go. Oh my gosh, Brandon! I appreciate you!
This place seems
quite
ordinary.
This seems
so ordinary that I don't even feel that it's worth investing.
I do have a joke in a second.
Same feeling here.
Wuwang Hill's unusual weather and peculiar surroundings are a source of constant rumors, most of which are untraceable and can never be proven. So, I suppose this could only be expected.
It seems you seldom have anything to show for all your efforts. Is that also due to your pure Yang spirit?
I guess so.
That is so rude.
Like I mentioned before, my Yang energy tends to just scare away evil spirits. You may think it's beneficial for me to have such a condition, and therefore there is no real need for me to practice thaumaturgy. But if I renounced my practice of thaumaturgy, and one day met an evil spirit that didn't fear my yang energy, then I may not be able to exercise it.
No wonder you're so persistent.
If I merely spend my time training without actually putting it into practice, then how would I ever know the fruits of my labor or what skills I needed to improve?
but to this very day, despite the many exorcisms I have performed, I have yet to see a single demon, not to mention one that I needed to defeat using thaumaturgy.
Chongyun's never seen a demon.
I shouldn't rant like that. I'm fine. I've gotten used to such feelings.
Don't give up, Chongyun.
Since we're already here, let's go check the two locations mentioned in the clue.
Okay, so now we're gonna go check the two locations in the clue. Is this the right?
I think it is. So let me know when I can do my joke, because
you can do your joke now.
Okay. So basically, if we were like messaging about this or whatever, about this idea that kind of we're like following a path and then like don't end up at like the destination that we should be at, kind of thing, I would absolutely like send you a GIF or at least a meme of the Emperor's New Groove bit where like Yzma and Kronk get there first, and it's like, how did we get here, Kronk? And it's like,
well, by all accounts, it doesn't make any sense.
Your Kronk voice is so good!
Oh, thank you.
It's so good! It literally does, and it's like amazing how they like acknowledge, like, because they would just be like...
That's why I love it, because it was like, I mean, that's sort of one of the reasons I liked really early like Family Guy as well, because of this kind of like awareness that it, you know, like sort of like the meta jokes. I'd never really seen like meta humor before, and not a load of stuff kind of had jokes where it's like, hey, this is a TV show, unless they were like really super obvious, say something like Saved by the Bell, where there'd be like the freeze frame and like they talk to the audience or something like that. Like that's kind of, but things where it's just like, this doesn't, you know, sort of. So, but yeah, but no, and thank you for liking my Kronk.
It's so good.
The poison for Cusco. Cusco's poison.
Cusco's poison.
That's why.
Squeakity, squeak, squeak, squeakers.
Squeakity, squeak, squeak.
Squeakity. Do you want to know the thing I do better? Because I can't really do deep voice as well. That's kind of like one of the.
That was so good. What are you talking about?
But another impression stemmed from me doing that voice, like learning I can do that voice. I can do it better if I'm not like talking for an hour and a bit dehydrated.
I know.
Like I know that sounds like excuses.
No.
But anyway.
Don't be so hard on yourself. You're awesome.
But the voice and impression, the other one, I should bring up the script for it really. But the thing I realized that I do better than Kronk is the like Kronk shoulder angel voice.
Yeah.
Because
it's like pitched
like,
up.
Because it's basically that pitched up. So it's like sort of like, you know. Sorry, I'm just trying to think of what bit of the script to start from. But like,
where he like,
where it's like, I'm gonna give you two reasons why you should just walk away. Number one, he's got that sissy stringy thing. We've been through this. It's a harp. Yeah.
It's so good.
That's a harp, and that's a dress robe. Number two, look what I can do.
Look what I can do.
And they're like, what does that have to do with it? No. He's got a point.
No, he's got a point. It's just so good.
Sorry, again, we're ruining the movie if you haven't seen it, but hopefully we haven't ruined it too much.
I don't think we're ruining absolutely anything. I think anyone here who hasn't seen Emperor's New Groove like, needs to leave this stream right now.
Go on Disney Plus after the stream. Not right now. After the stream, go on Disney Plus, find Emperor's New Groove.
Watch it tonight or today, whatever time it is. 5 a.m. person. Watch it now if you haven't seen it.
Yeah, yes, just stay up. Like, you've missed sleep now, so
it's
you've
missed sleep. Time over. It's Emperor's New Groove time. Oh my god, that's amazing. Okay, so I just found some strange smoke. Oh gosh, this is the best part. I'm, Bo, I don't know if you know, but after my streams, I go back and I put time codes, and normally it's like about what I'm do, like what has happened in the stream, like the last one, I was like starting the first ending, like second ending, third ending.
Yeah, yeah.
That's not how this is gonna go. It's gonna be like talking about bloopers,
flaming Cheeto.
Flaming hot Cheeto. Bo talks about spiciness.
The Kronk impression. Like, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Bo sings a song.
Who tell me out? Yeah. Bo sings a song. Who tell me out?
It's gonna be Bo does Emperor's New Groove impression. Kronk impression.
I love it. Yes.
Amazing. Oh, okay, so we're gonna talk to the smoke, I guess.
What's this?
not talk to it, but...
Yeah, so I think this sounds like we're gonna go back to Test of Courage, but I don't think we do. I think this does...
Oh, man. Okay, so... you said, Chongyun said the evil spirit may be here recently, and then our choice is, so it seems the clue was real, or great, our efforts have finally paid off.
I mean, both of those sound good to me. Perhaps, like, the efforts paid off is, like, a little bit more positive, because the first one has a bit of an inherent, like oh, it sounded crazy. Like, yeah, like, oh, that sounded like it could have been, you know. Whereas the second one's just like, yeah, you know.
Okay, so, great. Our efforts have finally paid off.
Yes. It was not all in vain. But we mustn't act rashly. If this mist remains here, it can easily contaminate the area. Once it contaminates monsters such as Hillichurls, it could even make them more aggressive and dangerous to anyone nearby. Or if it happens to contaminate any adventurers passing by, the consequences would be unimaginable.
I want to choose the one. It's your time to shine, Exorcist!
Yes, just do it. That's great.
Choose that one. It's your time to shine, Exorcist.
My pleasure.
My pleasure.
Let's inspect
That's
the surrounding area to see if there's any more mist like this. Once we've cleaned up this mess, we'll continue forward. Remember, there might be danger ahead. We should be prepared for a fight.
I'm gonna say, you're very thorough.
It's second nature to me. Exorcism is a solemn and serious matter. It's on me if you or anyone else gets hurt due to my negligence. There's no time to lose. Let's go.
Let's go!
It appears there are evil spirits here, and not the weak variety. Let's keep going.
I found another one! I also found some snapdragons and some mint. How exciting. Okay.
I suspected that there would be hilly
churls. Oh, no! There's hilly churls! Okay.
We mustn't let a single one escape.
I'm not gonna let you escape. Oh, I got them.
Okay, good.
These tracks are still fresh. It seems the evil spirit is on the move. The path ends here as well as the tracks. It'll be difficult to follow it any further.
I didn't think your pure yang spirit could be so powerful.
It must have sensed me as a threat from a long way off. That's why it ran with such haste. It seems that this is still not the kind of spirit that can overcome my abundant yang energy and fight me head on.
But if we don't deal with it, it'll just go somewhere else and harm people, right?
Don't worry. I'll continue tracking it for a few days. It won't dare show its face around here again.
Okay, so do I say, but you still won't ever see it, right? Or, it's a shame we can't take care of it for good. I feel like the second one?
Second one, yeah.
Okay. It's a shame that we can't take care of it for good.
Yes. Defeating it once and for all would certainly make all this worth our efforts. Why do you seem so disappointed?
I can't help but feel like this was a waste of our time.
No, quite the contrary. Not only did we clean up the traces of the evil spirit, but we also took care of those monsters.
You might say she can't help this feeling.
My only regret is that I didn't get to drive it away using my thaumaturgy. But I'm already prepared to spend my life chasing this goal, so I do not regret such disappointments.
I'm gonna say, I guess you're right.
Yes, so please, cheer up. Of course. I'd never wish for you to be in low spirits.
Aw, Chongyun!
Actually,
you're so nice.
I wanted to thank you for not leaving me, even with my special condition, and for helping chase the evil spirit to the very end. Even if we'd ended up running into an incredibly strong demon, I would have felt much safer with an experienced adventurer like you by my side.
Okay, so should I choose... I'm just doing my duty. Oh, Chongyun was like, thanks for staying by my side. Do I say, like, I'm just doing my duty, or your persistence made it hard for me to leave?
The first one.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm just doing my duty.
Well, I appreciate it. Oh, it seems the weather is starting to clear up over there. Let's go have a look.
Let's go have a look.
Perhaps there's nothing to worry about after all.
So I know this is like kind of long and dragging out. It's still one of those things where once you get like one of the endings, it's then like easy to then kind of complete the rest, like quick and easy to complete the rest.
Yeah, for sure. I'm gonna say, I'm not an evil spirit.
Oh, no, that came out wrong.
Chongyun just tried to call me an evil spirit. Rude!
We shouldn't focus only on the gains and losses of our journey. The things you see and the events you encounter along the way are equally important rewards.
Oh, we got to the one other ending! Cute. Okay, wait. So, let's go look and see.
So I was gonna say, should we kind of like, kind of maybe cool this here in a
That's
set?
What I was gonna say, because I feel like...
But maybe we'll just kind of check, can we just kind of check whether that kind of counted as like the first path or the second? I
didn't say we're there. So for Test of Courage, okay, so we did the Test of Courage one. This is the other path, not
this
Test of Courage.
This definitely is the other path, okay.
And yeah, so then the other path has two branches, it looks like.
Oh, I think
one,
I know.
Two, three.
Yeah, I think I know. Yeah, I think I know the kind of different things that they kind of are, if I have it right in my head. One's really funny and like abrupt. Like you won't be expecting the ending, and then it's just like the end, and it's like really funny.
Is it is it like fast? Like, should we try to just like do it?
I don't know how long it'll be till you get to that point, and I don't know.
Okay.
I can't remember the things we'd need to do to get to that point. Basically, without spoiling things, what kind of happen? Maybe it's like you need to have maybe you need to have no popsicles, but basically...
I think that that's what we had to do. I think we had to, because isn't one of them popsicle related? Because I think we had to say no to that kid. I think we had to give both of them to the kid.
Well, because basically there's a thing where kind of you're kind of like, oh, that kid really seemed to like or enjoy the popsicle. Or it's like, oh, hey, we could have given that kid more popsicles.
I think we have to give him both. Because it's like those are the only options, is one or both. I think we had to give him both. And then...
Like, yeah.
Let's see how fast it looks like it will be.
Because basically, he has a sister or something like that.
Yeah.
And I think there's kind of... And I thought one of the paths is kind of like, oh man, we could have given them like one each kind of thing. And it's like, well, hey, let's go find them and... give them some more or something like that. So
yeah.
That's why I kind of thought like one would be okay, because it's like nice to Chongyun, and I was thinking that they'll be like, oh, we didn't give them enough, let's go give them some. But yeah, so yeah, it was about like making popsicles, kind of the making popsicles, and like that kid is kind of like, because basically what happens is you kind of like talk to the kid, you talk about popsicles, you go do a little bit of stuff, and then afterwards you're like, oh hey, let's go see that kid again. And then that's kind of the, you know, it's like funny and charming. And
well, if you want us to call it, we can call it, or we can do the popsicle.
I'm happy to keep going. Just don't know how long it will draw things out, and I don't know how long you like your streams being and stuff like that, so I just don't want to make you do more than you
we can keep going, but only if you want to. Because I already went and got us to the point where we gave him the two popsicles. And then it says, I wonder how I'll manage without any popsicles. So it's, can't you buy some more? Or are they difficult to make? I think I'm going to say, are they difficult to make? Because aren't we going to try to make them?
Yes. Yeah, we'll go with that.
I'm going to say, are they difficult to make?
I usually get my popsicles from One Min Restaurant on special order. The ingredients are not complicated, but the restaurant is always bustling with business, and Chef Mao is usually too busy to take my order.
And see, speaking of making them, where would you make food? In a kitchen. That's why I was trying to get us to go to the kitchen earlier. Like,
I know, I totally get where you're going. I'm gonna say, I'll go with you.
Oh, no need. I'm sure I can manage it on my own.
Oh no. I'm gonna say, I was the one who convinced you to give away all your popsicles in the first place.
No, please don't feel at fault. I think you made the right choice. But if you're offering to come along, then I won't refuse.
Okay, so we're gonna go to the restaurant.
All right.
Now we go to the rest.
Okay. Now we go to the restaurant.
And then they all come out and go, happy, happy birthday, da-da-da-da-da-you,
da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Sorry. Hey!
Sorry.
No, well, I loved it.
Oh, this is bad. Chef Mao is not at the restaurant right now, and neither is Xiangling. We'll have to wait until he returns.
Remy.
What do we do about the evil spirits?
If it's not too difficult, I could try to make some.
Oh, are you a good cook?
Okay.
You're gonna make Remy treats?
We're making popsicles! I'm gonna say that making popsicles seems easy. Or, no, I should say I often cook for myself when adventuring in the wilderness.
Yeah, go with that. That's kind of...
I often cook for myself when adventuring in the wilderness.
Then I'll leave it to you. Thanks for your help.
Never mind, here you go. Do you know what ingredients we should use?
I'm afraid all I know is that it requires water. But to imbue the effect that suppresses my yang energy, perhaps something special is required. Like different plants, fruits, or herbs, for example.
It's literally flavored water. okay, I'm gonna say let's try. Okay, should we do Mistflower and Chingston or Sunsetia and Valberries? We're not gonna do chili. That's not nice.
I have no particular preference. If there's a particular bad guy, because you might have to like beat some.
I think I'm gonna do the Mistflower because I think the other one is like fruit, and I feel like that's a little too strong.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah. I was gonna say there is one where it's like it has like a it does have a strong flavor. Like the chilies are like heat, and then one's like strong flavor, and then the other's like very kind of neutral.
Everyone in chat wants us to do chili though.
You can if you want.
They said the chili is faster.
The chili is faster.
We're gonna do Mistflower. Unless you think we should do chili for funniness.
I mean.
Hey, this dog is drinking so much water. Relax.
It depends how long you want to go for and stuff like that.
No, we should do Mistflower. Okay, let's try Mistflower and Chingson.
Oh, that sounds about right. Coming up with the writing.
Oh, everyone's so mad. They wanted us to do chili.
You most certainly.
Well, I'll tell you what, because the chili is quite quick. We can probably go back and do the chili at the end.
Like very fast.
Sort of thing. Like once we kind of like have a path here, we'll do the chili at the end. Because I do like.
Oh yeah, no, I already have the ingredients.
Oh, okay, good. I remember it used to be like hard to tell if you had the ingredients. Like I remember when I did it with Chris,
so that seems kind of fast because I didn't actually have to do anything.
Yeah.
Finished. Oh, they look exactly like the ones Chef Mao makes for me. Let me try one. Yes.
Yay!
Good. This is the right feeling. I can sense the energy calming down within me.
These should help you keep control.
Thank you, Traveler. Now I have lots of popsicles. Your skills are amazing.
Aw,
if I'd known you possessed such skills, we could have made more for that kid and his family.
It'd have to be a lot more. I'm sure the kid would eat most of them and still be hungry.
Right. But he mentioned his family is not well off. I'd still like to help them if I can.
But what about your search for evil spirits?
Exorcism is my means of helping the people of Liyue live more peaceful and happy lives. If that kid really needs my help, then helping him would be just different means to the same end.
I'll go with you.
All right. I remember the kid mentioned that he was headed for Chihu Rock. Let's go find him.
Okay, so we're gonna go find the kid. Woohoo! Doo-doo. Okay, we're gonna give it to the kid.
Where did you get these? I didn't give you any Mora.
Oh no, the
you
mom's mad.
Them, did you?
Oh no.
No, I didn't steal them. I talked to a nice person and they just gave them to me.
Uh-oh.
So you've been asking for food on the street? I've already told you, such behavior makes you look uneducated.
Okay.
How could you ask a stranger for food? Is that any different from being a beggar?
But I didn't ask them for it. They asked me if I wanted some.
That's it. No more lies. Just be honest about your mistake.
Excuse me. He got those popsicles from me. He never asked us. We just gave them to him.
Yeah, this is the nice person I was telling you about.
Who are you?
My name is Chongyun. As you could probably tell from my attire, I'm an exorcist. Your son really seemed interested in popsicles, so we thought we'd make a batch for you. That's why we're paying you a visit.
There's no need to worry.
Oh, I see. Sorry, I seem to have misunderstood him. I'm sorry, DeLong. It was wrong for Mommy to blame you.
It's okay, Mommy. So, am I allowed to talk to the nice popsicle man now?
Sure. But please keep an eye on your sister. Mommy will be back after some errands, okay?
Don't worry.
Yeah, we probably shouldn't just be giving random children food.
Thanks.
Is, like, the mother still there?
She just left.
In big trouble again.
So, can I just point out a funny thing? And it is, like, so, because, like, literally a minute ago, you're like, oh, she's mad. And then she's, like, left us
like
with
her kids. Yeah, she was like, okay, bye!
Yeah, like, just going from, like, who are you? What are you doing with my children? To being like, okay, well, you can take
later.
Care of her.
Yeah, you can babysit. okay, I'm going to say, actually, we've made some more.
Oh, wow. Look at all the popsicles. Thanks.
Don't eat them all in one go. You'll get brain freeze.
Okay, I got it. Thanks, you guys. You're like heroes.
Oh, okay.
Heroes?
We're heroes.
Yeah. I've been telling a story to my sister recently, and she admires the story's heroes very much. They're chivalrous, just, and they help the weak fight against evil.
And the heroes always have a good partner. One hero can beat up two bad guys, but with a good partner, they can defeat even more. You two must be very good partners.
Well...
That's right. We're great partners. We're friends, Chongyun!
You two must get along well together.
Accept our friendship!
We're gonna go play right now.
I do have a thing to say in a minute, but I'll wait until...
Don't be so childish. I'm sure heroes like
should we play with them?
Important things to do.
Huh?
Yeah.
You mean you can't play?
It wouldn't hurt to go play a little, right?
Huh? Oh, sorry. Could I have a word with you, Traveler?
Okay.
They look so excited to play with us, but I'm sure they'll be disappointed if we refuse.
We should play with them, right? Let's go play with them for a while.
Sure. That's fine. But...
Something on your mind?
No, it's nothing. I'm just... a little bit worried. I spend most of my time purging evil spirits and practicing thaumaturgy. And besides my training, I also need to constantly focus deeply on my own emotions.
Chongyun's like, I literally will.
So, what I mean is that I seldom have time for anything
like, he'll
others would consider.
He's like, I've
fun.
Never played any games.
I don't even
I don't
know
how.
The first thing about playing.
Again, this is a point where SpongeBob jumps in and is like, F is
so
for friends.
Excited to play with us,
I love it.
I'm afraid they'll just find me boring.
Aww. I'm gonna say, don't worry, I've got you covered.
Ah, great. That's reassuring. All right, let's give it a try. But I'll need your help if I don't know what to do.
Aww.
Hey, they're back! So can we go play now?
Yeah. I'll try.
I'll try.
Yay! No need to be nervous. We're gonna have a blast. I know. Let's play hide and seek. You'll be the ghost, but don't peek until you count to 50.
Who? Me?
Let me play the ghost first.
Okay, we'll go hide now. You'll have to find all three of us if you want to win.
You'll never be able to find me.
You mean we just hide anywhere we want?
Of course, silly. That's the most fun part of the game. But don't follow me. There's only room for one person in my secret hiding spot.
All right. But I still don't really know what to do.
Who knows? Maybe you'll be good at this.
You're right. I'll give it a try.
Yay! Let's go hide! No peeking, yo!
Oh, man. We're actually playing hide and seek?
Yep. So when you're sort of at that point doing it, I have two things I'll say.
Okay. Say now.
Okay, so one, the next time you're at like a conversation-y part and stuff like that, I will go to the loo. So I think whilst we're in like chat mode, I'll kind of like ignore it. But whilst you're kind of like, you know, we're kind of like listening to Chongyun and your lines and stuff, that's a good chance for me to just quickly nip to the loo.
Totally.
So I'll do that. But then the other thing as well is I was just going to say, honestly, I know this sounds really corny, but I truly mean it. I do kind of feel like a big part of this year, like ever since, say, like that first Among Us stream and stuff, has kind of been like a hangout quest for me and you, Sarah.
Yeah!
Where, you know, our friendship has
totally
sort
well,
of
we didn't know each other.
Like, we didn't know each other.
Like,
yeah,
we were both in Trials of Mana, but we didn't know each other until like this year.
And like I've sort of said to Sarah, there was like a day where I suspect that maybe I like recorded after her. Like, I'm not sure. Like, there was a person who I kind of
You told me that you were like, I think we occupied the same space. I was like, I don't know.
Like, it could have been. I mean, if you're really thorough with like your dates and sessions and stuff, we could like literally look it up and find out. But we can also ignore it and just say that, yeah, that probably was a thing, and then it's
that,
like, definitely.
We should definitely,
you
know, say that because
we should just say it happened.
Yeah, we should and, just and, say.
Rather than find out, like, you know, the truth that actually, like, no, we never, like, we didn't even record in the same month or something like that.
No, I think we did, though. I think we did because.
I think we did.
We were in studio, so we had to be in studio. So I feel like we did, and we almost met our
we almost
paths
met before
crossed.
Before we met, yeah.
Before we became friends.
And I always like stories like that. I always like when like people's paths nearly cross. And I have a bunch of stories about that where like people I've nearly met and then I like didn't meet them and stuff
yeah,
like
I
that.
Love stuff like that. It's just like, especially because it feels like LA, like where we are. Is
yeah. Yeah, no, it really is. Yeah.
The biggest city ever, and you can get completely lost in it. And then it's like, it's actually such a small world, especially the voiceover community is a pretty small world. Like, there are, like, especially, like, the voice actors that are, like, working in things like video games, like, it is a relatively small world,
Oh,
in
definitely.
That sense.
And particularly, like, just, like, Burbank, because Burbank is kind of, because, like, there obviously is, like, LA, and there's, like, the whole of LA, but there are, like, a load of prominent studios in Burbank, which is kind of, like, in terms of square footage.
It's a small, like, it's not a very large place.
Like, it's a city, and it's densely populated. Like, it's way bigger than, like, my hometown in England, for example, in terms of number of people. But in terms of actual size, it's, like...
Pretty small.
Not. It's very small. So, But, like, so Burbank has a lot of, like, prominent studios, and so, you know, back before the pandemic, you know, you could sort of be going just around Burbank, and you could see someone, like, go into their session or finishing a session, or...
Right.
Like, even if you weren't, like, going to a studio, and even if they're not going to a studio, you might just be, like, going to one of the restaurants in Burbank, and they might be going there because, like, say they just finished a session, or they've... Or they're like getting some food before a session or something like that, you know, or they live in Burbank because Burbank's a more convenient place to live, or, you know, so like Burbank was a place and sort of is a place where you really can just bump into like all kinds of people who you know from, you know, games and anime and cartoon. And
yeah,
like,
it definitely,
and I have.
It definitely is. And I feel like a lot of people will like do a session and then will like go out for lunch after. And so then it's just like, I just feel like the probability of bumping into somebody that you know there is pretty high.
Yeah, I had it happen, like, so many times. And things where I'd be, like, hanging out with one voiceover friend, and then we'd like, bump into another, and it's just, it's kind of nuts, like, how often it happens. So, yeah.
First of all, I'm killing it at this hide-and-seek. I just found two of them! I
so
love
hang on,
it!
Hang on, have you found the two kids but not Chongyun?
Yeah.
Oh, so like that, like Chongyun is the winner. Hashtag Chongyun winner.
Hashtag like, Chongyun winner.
Like spam the comments with Chongyun won.
Except that I still have to find him.
Yeah, exactly. He won. He won hide and seek. Like he beat those kids.
Yeah. Beat those darn kids.
He beat those really young. Who like probably
like
don't know how to do
anything. Children.
Small young children.
And he's probably like so proud of himself too.
But yeah,
right?
when you do find him, that's when I'll nip to the loo. So let
yes,
me know when
yes,
you do
yes,
find
yes.
him.
Oh darn it. Where is this he?
This is actually like quite funny as well, given the like conversation that you'll have and stuff like that.
Oh, I just fell.
Oh no!
Where
what is,
this?
What is this? Breath of the Wild?
No, what is this? I didn't know I was playing Breath of the Wild! Oh gosh, no, but for real. The amount of times that I've... Is he like on the roof or something?
He's not on a roof, no. Well, I don't think he is. I don't think it was a roof that he's...
I feel like he probably is on the roof.
In my head, I can kind of like partially picture it, and I don't feel like it was a roof.
Okay, let's look for blue hair. I just climbed on the roof to see if I could see him.
The one thing I will say is definitely like pan the camera around, because I feel like when you find him, there's kind of like, there were kind of bits where I was like, oh, well, if you're looking from that angle, it's like, it's seemingly obvious. But I was like, but if you were like just over there and had a different camera angle, like you wouldn't be able to see him at all. So I guess just keep that in mind.
What? Pan the camera.
He'll probably end up on like some kind of roof, and I just apologize profusely. But I don't feel like it was. I don't really feel like it was a roof. It was kind of, if you're okay with me saying like a tiny thing, I felt like it was more. I mean, it had like an edge, like.
It's a, like a balcony.
Yeah, but that, like, so it might be something more like a balcony, like, but I didn't really, like, it, like, there was, like, an edge kind of thing, like, he's not, like, standing in, like, the, like, in, like, the open or anything, but I didn't really feel like, I don't think it was, like, a roof. It's not addressed in, like, the text or the speech or, like, the dialogue, kind of where he was, like, they don't really describe it in the text or anything, so I don't really know how I would describe it, and I'm like not a visual person. I kind of struggle to remember things visually, but in my head I can kind of see a thing, and the thing I see I wouldn't describe as a roof. I mean, feel free to stand on some roofs, and maybe if you stand on a roof, like, look down and see if you can then see him.
That's what I did. The chat is telling me hot and cold. Okay. This is the kind of backseat gaming I will allow in the moment. Okay, you have to tell me if I'm.
But instead of hot and cold, you have to say yin and yang. Yang being hot, yin being cold. So if Sarah's getting closer, you say yang. If Sarah's getting further away, you say yin. Yin yang, cold hot.
Yeah, if I'm close to him, you have to say yang. No, wait. If you guys are saying yin, then that means I'm far. Okay.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay.
Can I just say that's generally always a funny thing when you kind of like if the answer's no, but you have to sort of say like, and if you say like yes, kind of thing. It's like, but like yes, your no is correct.
Oh, everyone's
kind of
saying
thing.
Yang?
Like, that's always a funny thing. Yeah. Oh, getting hot, getting spicy.
Oh.
Flaming hot Cheetos.
Flaming hot Cheetos! Oh my gosh. Is he like here? Where is he?
This is. If I kind of remember like.
Oh, I'm going farther away. Okay.
If I remember like the conversation that you have with Chongyun. Again, because I can't remember all the different like variations of it there are and stuff. But if I remember some of the base version of like the conversation you have. This is actually hilarious.
Is he in the tree? Where is he?
He's not like in a tree.
Guys, y'all are not helping. They're saying the opposite things. This is unhelpful. I found him!
Yay! So what would you describe where he's standing? Would you describe it as like a roof or a balcony or
like
an edge?
He's like, yeah, like a balcony type thing. But it's not like a balcony.
It's like a little staircase. There's like a little staircase,
yes,
and he's like
yes,
behind
yes,
a
yes.
wall. Like he's like behind a wall adjacent to a staircase that's like on an edge or something, right?
Yeah. There's like a bridge, and then there's a staircase down, and then like there's like a railing. So like that, it kind of looks like a balcony in that sense. Why would you hide here?
I thought that this would be the perfect.
Right, I'm gonna nip to the loo.
Yes, go.
Methods of locating evil spirits. And I have lots of experience tracking down their hiding spots. This spot is dusty and a bit gloomy, which gives off an unsettling energy. Evil spirits usually prefer such places.
You're trying to use thaumaturgy to play hide and seek.
Yeah, I guess my experience as an exorcist doesn't apply very well. Since I've been found, I guess I must admit my defeat.
You definitely
It's a simple game, yet quite intriguing once you begin to play.
Maybe we could play it together again sometime.
Sure. We could invite more friends to join us.
More friends!
Let's go.
Yay!
Mommy's still not back yet.
Oh, no.
Oh, I'm starving. Do you two know how to cook at all? Don't be so selfish. They played with us for a long time already. Well, if we played for so long, then a little longer won't hurt.
No, it's all right. But I'm not too picky about the taste of food, as long as it doesn't make me feel unwell.
Which anything does.
Are you sick? Mommy says you should always take care of yourself.
No, it's not so serious. I just need to be careful about what I eat. For example, noodles with mountain delicacies. The dish tastes great, but I can't eat anything warm. So I came up with my own variation called cold noodles with mountain delicacies.
Okay, I'm back.
Yay! We're talking to the kids noodles. Now that I found you.
That sounds nice and cool. I want to try.
Let me know when I can just ask a question or comment about a thing.
You can comment right now. No, this is kind of boring.
Okay. So, when you talk to Chongyun, you basically kind of talk about how the hiding place he picked was not a good hiding place, right?
But he was the last one to be found.
Right, he was the last one to be found, and you like genuinely struggled.
Right.
Sorry, I'm just setting everyone up in the chat there by using the word struggled, but you like genuinely had a hard time finding him. So it's just funny that then they talk about how like, oh, you don't really know how to pick good hiding places, and it's like, well, I mean, it took like 5 minutes. Like,
yeah, it took a while. So then like. Then he, when he was like, his answer was just like, oh yeah, I suck. It's like, wait, so, it took a while.
How does it taste? Ah, that's a relief. I'm glad you like it.
Oh.
Let's serve the dish to the kids.
Okay, so then Chongyun just made like something.
Wow. It's
I just want to go back and give you the chili popsicle.
I've never had anything like
and then
this
we're going to call it a day.
Oh, so was that like the end? Was that like the end of the...
I think so.
Was that like an ending?
Well, not yet, but I'm assuming after we give the kids some food.
Yeah, like, so, like you, we are getting close to an ending, and then we'll do the chili popsicles,
yeah,
everyone.
Yeah, and then we're going to call it a night.
Because there'll be like a... Sarah will have like a big reaction to it, and then that'll kind of be a perfect place to end it.
And Beau, you could send us a selfie of yourself making a big... No, I'm just kidding. I'm going to say, seems you're becoming quite popular.
This is completely unexpected for me. I was sure that everyone would just think I'm boring.
Aww, no Chongyun, we don't think you're boring.
And if you weren't so
I think I'm boring.
that's
a thing we share in common.
No, Beau, you are not boring. What are you talking about?
Sarah, I spent 5 minutes talking about bloopers and Nintendo DS's. Like,
yeah, that's not boring. You have a personality. That's very interesting. Okay, we just got to this ending. I think you're very interesting.
Oh, well, thank you.
And
I think you're interesting too.
I think that you like. Oh, how do I get back here? Oh yeah, there. I think you're interesting because you know a lot about a lot of different things, and you can have interesting conversations about them all.
Oh, thank you. That is like legit a thing I strive for. I like to kind of know things. I'm not to like be a know-it-all, but I just like to try and understand about this world and to try and understand other people. And to and again, it's sort of it means that you can kind of communicate about more stuff. So yeah.
I think you're awesome, and I think that that's one of the things that makes you so great and interesting is that you do try to know a lot of things that you can talk about. And it makes you somebody that, like, no matter what the person knows or doesn't know, you can have a fun conversation with them. That, like, makes you... easier to have fun conversations with someone who, like, actively tries to know things, you know?
Yeah, yeah. No, thank you. I really appreciate that. I still don't know music, so I will still be like, did you know that this was a Rolling Stones song?
I love that, though. I think that's hilarious.
I think there was legit a song the other day that I... was like, oh, that's a Rolling Stones. Again, I've heard of the Rolling Stones, and there'll be a song where I, like, know the tune to it and, like, some of the words for it, but I, like, won't have, like, the putting the two together, just no idea.
Not important, you know? That's not an important life skill, I don't feel like. I feel like other things are more important.
As long as I, like, don't go on, like, a quiz show, I guess, ever, or something like that.
But it would be funny. Like, it would still be funny if you didn't know.
Sort of like, in what Mario Kart game was the first to feature the blooper? And it's like, I got this.
You're
and
like,
then, like,
I know!
It's, sort of, it's like, sort of like, you know, sort of what two, like, political positions did Andrew Yang run for? I got this. And then just sort of like, name a Rolling Stones song.
Well, okay, you know what? We could do trivia together because I feel like I know enough pop content. Not just like pop music, but like popular. Like, content, and you know everything else.
Okay, yeah, no. Well, deal,
actually,
deal.
If you, me, and my brother, my twin brother, Isaac, did trivia together, we would literally win every single time. Because, like, he knows everything, like, science. Like, he knows, like, so
Ooh,
much.
Yeah.
He also knows so many, like, he's also one of those people who knows a lot about a lot of things. And, like, he can, like, really talk about everything. So I feel like you, me, and Isaac, we would kill it at trivia.
It's actually just really cool to just know random things. Like, I think there was a thing that I didn't get to talk with Core about last time. I think I talked with it about them, like, after the stream, but not on the stream. And there's this whole thing about cows, and there's this whole crazy thing where, like, cows kind of have, like, holes put into the side of their body where, like, farmers can literally, like, reach inside the cow from the outside of the cow and reach into their stomachs.
What?
Yeah, what? you can like basically kind of like cut open a hole in a cow and like when I say a hole, I don't mean like a pinhole. I mean like something that a farmer could like reach what? His arm what? Into.
What? See, why? So, like,
so you can do this thing called fistulating, which I know that sounds kind of dirty.
I actively hate it. I hate everything about that term. I hate it.
But it's a thing where you can kind of like say take, if a cow is like sick, you can get good bacteria from a healthy cow and sort of then put it like directly into the stomach of an unhealthy one. And so
nay,
you can
nay,
make
nay.
A cow better.
Nay, nay, nay. Don't enjoy it. Unsubscribe. Why is this a thing?
But basically a cow can survive with like having a, like, I mean they close the holes up kind of thing, like they put a sort of like a cap kind of thing on that you can like screw on and off, but you can basically cut a forearm sized hole into a cow, into the side of a cow that can like reach through to its stomach and then sort of like affix like a cap type screw thing onto it, and a cow will survive this, and it like doesn't feel it. It's like nothing. It's not uncomfortable for them or anything. They don't know and they don't care, and it's like just so get random stuff like that. Like just
that's
yeah.
Amazing. That is amazing. And now we all know something more about cows that we didn't know before. So this is a win for us. This is a win.
So back to the popsicle making.
Okay, so we're gonna try this option. Let's try Jaehyun chili and slime condensate.
That sounds a little dangerous. But as the saying
goes,
oh
yeah, because you probably already have the
fire
ingredient.
With fire. I trust your.
I think
judgment.
It's like Jaehyun. Jaehyun.
Jaehyun Karst is how.
Jaehyun or something like that.
No,
yeah.
I think it's like Jaehyun Karst. That's like the place.
Have you prepared all the ingredients?
I think,
for the
I don't know. I have to have them remind me every time I go into record. I have this. Oh no, I have to go get this ingredient! And I need slime condensate.
Does it like tell you how/where to get it at least?
No. Or maybe it does. Let's see.
Have you procured all the ingredients for the.
I think that was a thing in like the original. Either the original Xenoblade Chronicles or Xenoblade Chronicles X, going back to my Nintendo geekiness here.
Jaehyun. Yeah, right? Oh no, I just...
I think it was like Jew, because I feel like I remember in my head, because again, I sort of see like J-U-E, and I kind of would think like Jue, like Buen or something like that, you know, like Italian, like it would be like a Bue, but it's not like a Jue or something like that. I think it was like sort of in my head, I remember kind of visualizing it as like J-O-O, so I think it is like Juyen, something like that.
Oh my gosh, we'll have to ask Chris, because I honestly don't know. Guys, where do I find these chilies? I know I always say don't backseat game, but... Oh, I have...
The chat will just spam Flavor Town.
No, I tried to give it to him. And it didn't let me. I'm gonna go to Chinxa Village. If I can find it. Hello, Chinxa Village! There it is. Guys, I looked at my inventory! I don't have any, see? Do I?
Sorry, just be hilarious if you then did.
In this tab?
Oh, wait.
I have 17! What? Where? I feel like I'm hallucinating. What? I don't even see the number 17. Oh! And never mind! Okay, so then, okay.
So do you still need the other thing, or do you
Let's
have that
see.
As well?
Oh, wait. No, I have 116. So.
Okay. See, I think Chris Never had the same mind. Thing as well. Like, I think it. Like, I think there's a thing that says zero, but that's like how many you've selected to give, kind of thing.
It like, and then, wouldn't let me give him. Okay,
like,
okay.
Like, it doesn't say how many you have. It's like how many have you offered up for the like that. So.
Oh, I see.
Oh yeah, I'll say my Xenoblade thing in a second, because I imagine everyone really cares about that and was just
they do
waiting on tenterhooks for me
they
to
do.
Finish
they do, okay, now that we're not struggling!
Let me try one.
Oh.
Okay. Here it goes.
Sorry, I didn't know if that was actually a genuine invitation to start talking about
it's
Xenoblade
so
again, or whether we're still...
My throat is on fire.
Oh. One sec.
No, no.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Chongyun! Well, oh, no. Chongyun passed out. Worst friend ever! Okay,
and there we
now
go.
It's Xenoblade time.
No, yeah, I was just going to say that I think there was a thing in, and it was either the original Blade X. I haven't played 2. That'll be probably not this Christmas, but the next one. Like, I think sometimes there'd be, like, fetch quest items for certain items, and they, like, drop off, you know, they're sort of, like, enemy drops kind of thing. And there were, like, certain things where it tell... If it was, like, oh, go defeat this, like, certain type of enemy, it would, like, tell you where they are. So you'd, like, go and fight that enemy. But then if there was, like, an item drop, it... And or this could be, like, the other way around. But then, like, say if you had, like, an item drop, it wouldn't be, like, oh, if you fight enemies in, like, this area... If you fight, like, these kinds of enemies, you could get that item. There was something like that where, for like, one thing... It already did this very similar thing, where it was, like, go here and you will achieve... You will be able to achieve blah, blah, blah. Like, you may find this enemy, or may find this item. But then there was something which was, like, essentially the same thing, or, like, really similar. Like, they could... Or where you're, like, they could have done this with this as well. But so you're basically just, like... If you like, you didn't say no the enemy that you needed to defeat to get that item, you'd just
right.
have to, like, kill loads of different types of enemies until you luck out and get one of the items. So if you didn't have any of the items, I'd like to hope and think that the game would tell you, like, where
I
you
think
could
it
go
will.
Get them.
I think it'll tell you, like, some things, but other things it won't. Like some things that you need to level up, like, you can click on it and it'll tell you where to find it. But I don't know for
okay.
everything if it will. I think for most things it will, though. We did get a super chat. Satella said, R.I.P. Chongyun, frowny face. At least no pigeons were harmed in this hangout except for chicken noodle soup. No! chickens, p- Pigeons and chickens are different. Not the same. In the game, they make them the same, but in my mind, they are not.
Thank you, Satella.
This has been an amazing stream. Thank you so much for being here with me, Bo.
Thank you, Sarah. I've loved this. I've just felt so relaxed and had so much fun. I've really enjoyed it. I hope we get to do something else in future. Maybe we'll do Mario Kart or something.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We can play Mario Kart whenever you want. I'm really bad. but yeah, we should plan like another kind of like the Jackbox stream that we did. Another like chill.
But yeah, we'll figure something out.
Everybody, please go follow Bo on Twitter and Instagram. Both links are in the description of this video. And I will be adding time codes afterwards so that about all of the funny things that Bo said. If you want to go back and rewatch. And is there anything you'd like to say before we say goodbye, Bo?
No, just thank you all for watching. Thank you for the super chats. Thank you for, you know, helping Sarah when we got lost and stuff like that. And,
Thank you, chat. Thank you so much.
But no, and just no, thank you for your interest. Thank you for loving the game. Thank you for loving Chongyun. Thank you for like kind tweets and Instagram messages and all that other stuff. Like this year has been amazing and I'm really grateful to you all. You know, just, and it's funny, on Monday, I'll do like a tweet and an Instagram about this or whatever, but like on Monday, it will be like 1 year since I announced that I was Chongyun.
I love that!
So that's really cool.
That's amazing! Well, I know that you and I both feel the same about Genshin in so many ways, and that we love being a part of it, and we're so grateful that it connected us to this wonderful community. So thank you again, everybody, for watching and for being a part of the Genshin community with us. And Bo, thank you again for coming on stream. I really, really appreciate it. This was so much fun. I had a blast.
Yeah,
I'm so glad you came.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
And I also want to thank my mods. Mods, say hi in the chat so I can thank you. Individually, Brandon, thank you so much for everything you do. I think I saw Raya here. Thank you so much. Anyone else of my mods who are here, say so I can say thank you. I know Diamond was here earlier. Thank you, Diamond. And I think that's it. We'll see what they say if anyone else is here. And Loxiel's here. Yay! Thank you so much, Loxiel. Again, thank you to all my mods. I could not do it without you. You're amazing. And this is it. This is the end of the stream. Good night, everybody. Thank you again, Bo, for everything. And yeah. That's it.